usual. It shows the spirit on the part of both teams.
One thing you might look for early in this football game, and that is that Boston College has had first quarter trouble with their opponents. They have been outscored 23-6 in first quarters. We'll tell you more about that. Let's go down to the field now in the coin flip. And elected to make its decision in the second half, and they will kick off to start the first half. This is the same crew that we had at the Pitt West Virginia game last week with referee Raymond Bauer, and the umpire is Ronald Flagis. The head linesman, Burl Snell. Stan Kemp is the line judge. Jim Klingensmith is on the crew, along with John Daniels and Joseph Dorenzo. So we're about set now for the start of our football game. Boston College will get the football first, which means this young man will go right to work.
And this young man is getting better with every football game. His first game of the season was here against Brigham Young in the kickoff classic. A lot of pressure on him. The heir apparent to Doug Flutie. He had a lot of trouble in the first game. But since then, he's getting better and better. Bicknell says he's executing extremely well, and he's certainly pleased with the progress he's made.
We talked about the roller coaster season, Bruce, that Boston College is having. More specifically, as you indicated, they lost to BYU here in the kickoff classic 28-14. Then they came back and beat Temple 28-25, but they led by two touchdowns late in the game. They lost to Maryland then 31-13. However, they came back to beat Pittsburgh 29-22 on some last-minute heroics by Halloran and Kelvin Martin. And then lost to Miami last week 45-10 in the only game that they really have been out of from early on in the football game. And so if you look for alternate Saturdays, this is really Boston College's week to win. However, I might even say in the loss to Miami, Halloran did complete his first 11 passes despite putting only 10 points on the board.
I think Boston College's scores really are not fair because they don't reflect the way the team has played. They've given up a lot of big plays, specifically against Miami, against BYU. They allowed Robbie Bosco to throw for over 500 yards. And what they really have to get going on today is watch the breakdowns defensively. When the quarterback scrambles, don't give up. Stay with your man. Don't miss your assignments.
Being a native of this area, you're well familiar with this stadium, Bruce, and you were remarking before the ballgame, this is not the kind of stadium that people decide at 12 o'clock, let's go out and see a college football game. There's not a big walk-up crowd here, and the rain probably was a deterrent. As I mentioned, about 11:15, 11:30, the skies opened and the rain came down in buckets, and a lot of people who may have been vacillating apparently decided to stay home.
And I think it's going to be a late-arriving crowd today because of the rain earlier this afternoon.
Tracy Giles, number 30, and number 21, Tyrone Taylor, in the deep receiving spots. And here is the boot by Tom Angstead. And we're underway, and the kick down the far sideline goes into the end zone. And it's a touchback, and will come out to the 20-yard line. And that's where Boston College will put it in play. So the BC Eagles on the touchback will start from their own 20-yard line on Angstead's kick that went into the end zone. And there you see Sean Halloran, the starting quarterback for Boston College. And here's the starting lineup. He will go with Troy Stratford. His outstanding tailback is back after missing a couple of ball games. Ken Bell, the fullback. Kelvin Martin and Darren Flutie, the wide receivers. And Scott Gieselman is a tight end. And the offensive line, they have switched at the last moment. Gowetsky is not the center. Darren Twombly is the center. And Jim Ostrowski is in at left guard. Here we go. First down. That's Stratford. 25. Outside to the 28-yard line, goes down in a puddle of water. He is ripped down by Gene Austin, number 26, the cornerback on the far side, but not before he gained about 7 yards.
And he gives the BC Eagles an added dimension. Stratford can run with the football.
Here's the defense of Rutgers, Hope, Getzendanner up front, along with Pacal and Sagnella. And the linebackers are Pacal, Stowe, and Bachman. Actually, Pacal is a stand-up end. Austin, Brittingham, Morrow, and Twombly round out the secondary for Rutgers. It is second down and a short two now for the Eagles. And the give is Ken Bell. And he crashes across the 30 to about the 33-yard line and picked up a Boston College first down.
Kenny Bell is a converted tailback to fullback, and there's Mike Ruth, the man we'll keep our eye on this afternoon. 6'2", 249, bench presses over 540 pounds, All-American. They call him the Sultan of Sack. And he is headed for the priesthood following his career at Boston College and perhaps a career in professional football.
Bell is the lone setback. And the tight end, Casparello, number 85, now in motion to the far side, and he comes back to the near side. First pass of the day for Halloran. Throws an out pattern, and it is short of the intended receiver, Darren Flutie, up around the 40-yard line. It goes an incomplete pass. Quambley had the coverage. It'll be second down at 10. Boston College now running the ball from their own 32.5-yard line.
Darren Flutie, of course, the younger Flutie. Played tailback a little bit against Pittsburgh earlier in the year. He's like Ryan Brennan and Gerard Phelan. Ends that preceded him here at Boston College. Has good hands, runs good routes, not blazing speed.
Tracy Giles, now they shift, and the quick give is to Bell on a quick count, and he gets only a couple of yards. A good defensive play by Rutgers. The man who made the stop is number 50, George Pacal, 6'1", 235-pound senior, and as you know, one of four Pacal brothers. Two of them play on this team. One, of course, now Bill Pacal with the Los Angeles Raiders, and as the story always goes, invariably, the fourth brother in high school, they say, is the best of them all. It remains to be seen. Third and seven, Boston College at the 35-yard line. Halloran has all day, and his pass is knocked down at the line of scrimmage. He tried to get it to his big tight end, Scott Gieselman, and Getzendanner got a hand on it, knocked it down, and so Boston College now will have to punt the football away.
Getzendanner getting the start today over the injured Harry Swain, got the arm up, made a fine play defensively.
Steve Peach is back in punt formation, and Will Dunster in single safety back at his own 23-yard line. And this punt by Peach will come from the neighborhood of his own 25-yard line. Good snap. And he gets off a line drive. Dunster will let it bounce. Fields the ball to 20. And will be tackled. Fumbles the ball, and I believe Boston College has it. Dunster picked up the bouncing football at his 20-yard line, was decked at the 18, fumbled the ball, and Boston College has recovered. Jeff Oliver flopped on the ball at about the 16-yard line. What a break.
Well, it's going to be a slippery field for quite a while, and the ball comes bouncing down, and Dunster might have thought twice about picking up this ball on a slippery turf. He tries to get away with it, loses the football. The Eagles get a big break early and capitalizing on the wet playing surface. Here's Dunster trying to decide, should I pick it up or not? Decides to take the football. Tackle loses the ball, and the Eagles are in business quickly.
We're back live from the I formation. The pitch is to Stratford. He sees no hole, straight ahead, and cuts off to his right inside the 15 to about the 13-yard line. Fumbled the ball, but after the whistle had blown, he was stopped there by George Pacal again. So the big right tackle has made his presence felt early on in this ball game. A gain of about three. Let's make it second down and seven for Boston College running the ball. Make it a gain of two. Second down and eight. Running the ball now from the Rutgers 14-yard line. Flutie is the wide receiver to the right, and they send now Martin to the left side. A lot of motion. Now Flutie goes to the left. From the eye. Halloran looking downfield. Short pass and going down in the water at the 13-yard line with Steve Williams into the tailback position, the sophomore out of Providence, Rhode Island. Tyrone Stowe was there to make the tackle on him, but I think probably the water was as much a deterrent as was Stowe.
Well, Stowe is pretty tough. Watch the play now. He sets up the screen to his left. Halloran taking plenty of time, definitely looking for the screen all the way. Now watch Stowe come over from his linebacker position and say, you're going to turn on me, and that's not easy to do in this water. Stowe is all over the football field, a little better against the rush than the pass, but improving on the pass.
Third down, seven. Remember, Jack Bicknell in our pregame show talked about having to cash from these opportunities. Halloran's going to roll right. Throws one into the end zone, and it's incomplete. He just threw it away. The pressure was on. Rutgers had good pursuit.
And Rutgers came with a blitz that time. Bachman and Stowe both coming, and Getzendanner from his tackle position also putting pressure on Halloran. And now Boston College looking at a field goal situation. And Sam, they have not kicked very well this year. They're going with a freshman place kicker, and it's a big difference.
You are right. David Rooney is only one out of five in the field goal department. Darren Clooney will hold. Rooney, a left-footed kicker. The spot will be from the 19-yard line, an attempt at 29 yards. The placement, the kick is up, and it is good. So Rooney is hit on a 29-yard field goal following the Rutgers fumble, and Boston College has drawn first blood in this football game. There is a timeout on the field, and the score is BC 3 and Rutgers nothing.
Daily's cocktail mixes at your favorite store.
Call this toll-free number to get in on a special half-price offer. The sporting news delivered straight to your mailbox every week at a hefty saving.
You'll get the latest lowdown and the hottest showdown. The facts, the quotes, the trends, the drafts, all through the NFL season on to the playoffs and the Super Bowl.
Call toll-free 1-800-826-8080. You pay in three easy installments of only $4.96 each. Call now 1-800-826-8080. That's 1-800-826-8080.
A reminder that the broadcast and cablecast rights to this game are granted by Rutgers University to TCS. Any rebroadcast or other use of this telecast without written consent is prohibited. The announcers on this telecast have been hired and paid for by TCS in consultation with Rutgers University.
Boston College has to breathe a little bit better now. They have to feel pretty good about their field goal kicker, freshman David Rooney, who replaced veteran kicker Kevin Snow. Snow led the team in scoring last year with 12 for 16 in the field goal department. And coming into today's game, Rooney was only 1 for 5. He's now 2 for 6.
There are your deep men. Albert Smith, number 33, and number 82, Brian Cobb. And Rooney, the left-footed kicker, a line drive downfield to Albert Smith. He fumbles the ball at the 5-yard line, picks it up to the 10, and he is snowed under at the 13-yard line. Good special teams coverage by Boston College. Of course, Smith gave them the opportunity as he fumbled the ball at the 5-yard line. The first man to hit him was Kevin Sullivan, number 37. And so Rutgers' first offensive possession of the day. And there's your starting quarterback, Joe Gagliardi, his first start ever. And they'll go with Prescott and Smith in the same backfield, Cobb and Raffelli. And the tight end is Allen with Brenner, Udovich, Fine, Getz, and Keating. From the 15-yard line now, the Scarlet Knights. Make it the 14-yard line. Tight end Scott Allen comes to the near side. Gagliardi, play action pass. Tried to deliver the ball, brought it down, and ran with it up to the 20-yard line. He wanted to deliver the ball, I believe, to his tight end Scott Allen. But he was covered, and John Bosa made the tackle up around the 20-yard line, but Gagliardi running the option very well.
And one of the reasons he's starting today is because of his mobility. There's the defensive front unit of BC. The nose man, Mike Ruth, has been outstanding all season long, and Chuck Gorecki at the left end also tough. Linebackers both tough, Romanowski and Gaffney. Secondary very shaky so far in the season, but Neil Eitan is a seasoned veteran.
Cobb is wide to the right and Raffelli to the left on a quick count. Handoff is to the tailback, Albert Smith, and he is ripped down in the backfield by whom else? Number 68, Big Mike Ruth. You've heard the name, obviously. He is a leading candidate for all of the linemen awards, the Lombardi Trophy, the Outland Trophy, and everything else.
Now let's have a little bit of fun with Mike Ruth. Playing off the center, Glenn Fine breaks to the outside, takes Albert Smith down with two arms on one big leg. Nice play by Ruth.
Third down and four now for Rutgers in their first possession. The ball is just inside their own 20-yard line. Gagliardi now moving Albert Smith in. They run from the pro set backfield. Gagliardi over the middle. It's complete at the 23-yard line. That'll be close to a first down. He was tackled by Vincent Munn, number 28, the junior out of Jersey City, New Jersey, and that will be very close to a Rutgers first down. They had to get to the 24-yard line.
And that is good.
They move the sticks. They give them the first down. The ball is right on the 24.
Now, this is the first time in 4 years that Albert Smith, who has led the Scarlet Knights in rushing his first 3 years at the school, is in the fullback position. He is a tailback, and because Rutgers is looking to get a little bit more speed in the backfield, and because of an injury to fullback Vernon Williams, Smith starting at fullback, Prescott at tailback.
Raffelli is wide to the right, and in the slot is Brian Cobb on first and 10 Rutgers. And a misdirection, Gagliardi gives the ball off to Prescott, I believe. A flag is down, and he'll be tackled. Prescott the ball carrier, but a penalty marker down as he gained about a yard or two. And the indication, preliminary sign, holding against the Scarlet Knights, and it'll come back.
You heard Dick Anderson talk before the game saying, we've got to execute. We've got to stop making dumb penalties, and we've got to cash in when the opportunities present themselves. These are the type of infractions that have hurt the club in the first three games.
Holding on the offense, 10 yards, first down.
This series goes back to the year 1919, and one would think that any series that goes back that far would have a long and storied history, but the fact of the matter is they've only met six times. Boston College leads the series 5-1. Rutgers won the first encounter back in 1919 and has proceeded then to lose the ensuing 5 games.
The renewal, if you will, was 1981.
Three wide receivers now in on first down at 20. Gagliardi play action. Looking downfield, pressure, throws the ball. It's tipped, and caught! Down the far sideline with the ball is number 82, Brian Cobb. And he's finally brought down in the neighborhood of the 35-yard line, but the ball was deflected twice. And ever the opportunist, Brian Cobb came down with it. He got a block from Mike Degnan and carried the ball all the way down to the 33-yard line.
Watch Cobb, bottom of your screen, number 82. See him? He's cutting into the play. Gagliardi is looking for him. He's the primary pass receiver in this play. The ball is thrown in the direction of Cobb. It's tipped once, tipped twice. Cobb is still running his pattern down the right side. The ball falls in his arms, and Cobb picks up excellent yardage on the play.
53 yards in all, and Rutgers sets up shop now at the Boston College 33-yard line. So both the teams have had a break in this game. Here is the give now to Prescott. He has stopped right at the line of scrimmage for absolutely no gain. The Boston College defense now trying to get pumped up a little bit. Number 29, Matt Prescott, the ball carrier. 5'8", 190-pound sophomore out of Williamsboro, New Jersey.
Well, they say to be good, you have to be lucky. And the good are lucky.
So it's second down and 10 now, Scarlet Knights. Hoover comes wide to the left. They've got a slot to the left and only one setback. Gagliardi, quick out, pass caught by Prescott, and he's hit immediately at the 30-yard line. Good defensive play there by number 43, Neil Icon, who was a senior out of East Orange, New Jersey. Boston College comes to town here, Bruce, with at least 8 or 9 players who were born and raised in the state of New Jersey.
Well, Jack McNeil's roots are in New Jersey, and he likes to go there for recruiting purposes. Icon is the veteran back there, right cornerback. He has 1 year of experience under his belt. He played his high school ball at Montclair Immaculate Conception High School, and Icon came up to make the fine hit.
It is third down, and about 6 now for Rutgers to keep the football. Lone setback is Albert Smith, and Gagliardi back to pass. Over the middle, wide open, at the 25 to the 20. First down, Rutgers at the 15-yard line. The big tight end, Scott Allen, number 88, who is the favorite receiver of Gagliardi, came free across the middle and caught the pass for the first down.
Rutgers likes to go to their tight end. Gagliardi back to throw. Allen cutting across the middle. He has 9 catches coming into this football game. A little bit of a surprise, a 6'2 senior from Bridgeton, New Jersey, but not much experience coming into this year. He's starting to develop.
Dick Anderson along the sideline. He is now blocked out of your shot. He has the blue sweater on. It is first down and 10 to go now for Rutgers. On a quick count, Smith to the line of scrimmage, and that is it. He is stacked up there in the middle. Making the tackle, number 53, is Bill Romanowski, the leading tackler on the Boston College team. Sophomore out of Vernon, Connecticut, a gain of about a yard, second down and 9.
Well, Joe Gagliardi so far, 4 for 4, 76 yards. And according to Coach Dick Anderson, Rusty Hochberg has not collapsed and not done a terrible job, hence the change at quarterback. He said Gagliardi has just done such a very good job that he deserved a start. Coming off the bench in the first 3 games, throwing for 65% completion percentage.
Under 6.5 minutes to play first quarter. Boston College leads 3-0. Rutgers on the drive. Back this time to Curtis Stevens for a couple of yards. And Rutgers has not been able to run very well against the Boston College defense. Gagliardi has gotten most of the yardage through the air. A gain of about two. It'll be third down for Rutgers again and about 5 or 6 yards now to keep the football.
Well, Rutgers has been down here before. Last week against Penn State, they moved the football down to the 3-yard line and couldn't get in. So they know they've got to execute down near the goal line. They've got to come up with some points here.
And you might look for Scott Allen again. Big number 88. He is lined up on the right side of the line of scrimmage. From the I formation, Prescott is a tailback. Hoover in motion, and it's a pitch. Prescott to the 10. He is shy of a first down. He might have lost his balance there, too, Bruce, in the water and trying to cut back. The footing is not firm, although this particular field drains very, very well.
It'll dry quickly. A little conservative for third down. Rutgers keeping the football on the ground. Stevens leading the blocking. Prescott with probably the best speed in the backfield. Didn't really have any place to go, and Rutgers will try the field goal. Tommy Angstad is on.
Angstad will attempt the field goal. They'll spot the ball at about the 17-yard line. A kick of 27 yards. The placement of the kick by Angstad is up, and it is perfect. So we've had an exchange of field goals here in the first 9 and a half minutes of the first quarter. There's a timeout on the field. The score is now Boston College 3, Rutgers 3. We'll be right back after this.
Where is everybody going?
They're all going to Gateway Olds on Route 22 in Bound Brook. This is your last chance to buy 85 Tornados and Delta 88s. They're all in stock and available for delivery within 1 hour. So hurry! The cars at Gateway Olds are going fast.
Are you knocking yourself out looking for advertising that works?
Yeah.
You've tried almost everything, right? Newspapers, radio, even direct mail, and you're still not getting results, right?
Right.
Well, cable advertising is the answer. Cable reaches the market and customers your business needs. The channel selection offers you, the advertiser, the media variety to achieve those elusive results. Call TKR Advertising today at 356-1220. We've got the solution.
Big Mike Ruth was able to help Boston College shut down the run, but of course he can't defend against the pass very well, can he, Bruce?
No, he can. The big play in that drive, the 53-yard pass play, the tip play, Gagliardi to Cobb, Angstad converting with the field goal, and with 3-3 early.
We've talked earlier in setting up this game that both secondaries have had trouble defending against the pass. Here's Angstad's kick. It's a line drive, and it's fielded down at the 5-yard line. Taken by Tyrone Taylor to the 25, gets a block and outside, 35 and out of bounds in front of the Boston College bench near the 38-yard line. An excellent return of 33 yards by Tyrone Taylor, and he's run out there by Mike Copeland. And so Boston College will put it in play from there.
First game back for Tyrone Taylor, he had turf toe. It might not sound serious, but what it is stretched ligaments in the big toe. With a preseason injury, finally getting back today. And Taylor with a pretty return out to the 38-yard line.
And so Halloran now sets him up with a slot to the left. He's got two tight ends, both Gasparello and Gieselman on first down. 85 is Gasparello in motion. And he gives to Stratford for about 3 very tough yards. Trying to get outside. He is knocked out of bounds in front of the bench of Boston College. And the man making the stop was Tyrone Stowe, number 41, that big middle linebacker, who's a junior out of Passaic, New Jersey. And probably has some comps out here today, huh? There's your scoring drive.
Well, I think Stowe enjoys playing against good football teams. He says he misses Flutie today. He's seen Flutie for a couple of years. He says, I like that challenge. I like playing against the best.
Second down and 7. Now Gieselman flops sides and goes to the left side. Halloran back to pass. He's had time to throw the ball, but the secondary of Rutgers played very well. Completes this one to the 47. It'll be shy of the first down. Tackle made by Matt Backman, the junior linebacker. Stratford out of the backfield with a completed pass, but he'll be a couple of yards shy of the first down.
Backman right on top of this play. If you're Rutgers defensively, you've got to respect the talent of Stratford. He's a very good pass receiver for a running back. Backman came up to make the hit, brings up a third down and short.
Stratford's eighth kick catch of the season. Third down and two, single back in the backfield behind the quarterback, Sean Halloran. He's looking out for Stratford. Pressure on, delivers the ball. It's dropped at the 50-yard line. Good double team on the intended receiver, who I believe was Casparello. And Rutgers again holds Boston College at bay. And their coverage has been surprisingly good.
And Sean Halloran had a lot of time at the beginning of that play. And all of a sudden, Jake Jetson-Danner, the 6'4 senior from Catonsville, Maryland, broke through. Put a little bit of pressure on Halloran. And the net result, incompleted pass.
Steve Peach, who, by the way, is also the backup quarterback for Boston College, arches a high spiral. Dunster fumbled the first one. Fair catches this one at the identical spot where he lost the last one. 15-and-a-half-yard line, and that's where Rutgers will put it in play. 3:16 to play, first quarter. A timeout on the field. Boston College 3, Rutgers 3. We'll be back right after this.
In an hour or two, these streets will be teeming with people, all going after the same thing, the American dream of success. But while there are millions of men and women chasing the American dream, there's only so much of it to go around, which is why you should subscribe to the Wall Street Journal. Each business day, the Journal gives you a real competitive advantage with comprehensive news coverage, analysis, ideas you can put to excellent use in your work, and business information you won't find anywhere else. Of course, you don't have to subscribe to the Journal, but in a very short time, these streets will be filled with people who do.
Call 800-527-2600 for this new Journal offer. 13 weeks for just $28 with a money-back guarantee. 13 weeks, $28. Phone 800-527-2600 now for the Wall Street Journal.
I hope you'll be with us for our next telecast of Eastern College football. It'll be next Saturday, October 12th, 12 noon. The Rutgers Scarlet Knights meet the Temple Owls at the Vet in Philadelphia. Bruce and I will both be there for that one on the TCS Sports Network. 3-3 is the score here. Rutgers starting from its own 15-yard line. A wing to the right, and the lone setback is Albert Smith, and he gets the ball from Gagliardi into the middle of the pile for a couple of yards. It is tough going if you're going to run over Mike Ruth, I can tell you that.
That defensive front is very big. Not only Ruth, but John Boza, 6'4", 265 at one tackle. And at the other tackle, Mike Degnan, 6'4", 253. So that Rutgers offensive line is giving away some pounds in the trenches.
They are an undersized team, and also they don't have a lot of backup. What you see from Rutgers is what you get. Their people play most of the game. Dick Anderson a little lean on reserve, second down and eight. Prescott in motion. Gagliardi, a flare to Smith. Great defensive play by Boston College. Knifing through to make the tackle, number 95, Chuck Gorecki, who diagnosed the pass out in the flat, beat the blocker to the ball carrier, and dropped him behind the line of scrimmage.
Good play by Gorecki, one-fifth of the group they call Murderers Row. Here's the screen set up. They like to get Albert Smith out in the flat, but Gorecki was right there and made a solid tackle.
Third down and 13 now for Gagliardi and the Rutgers Scarlet Knights in a 3-3 football game. It has stopped raining and it started to cloud up again here this afternoon at the Meadowlands. And a whistle before they ever get the playoff. Maybe Gagliardi came out of there without the ball. It is the illegal procedure against Rutgers. It'll be third down and 18. Have you got a third and 18 play for the Scarlet Knights?
I think it's a tough situation, too, because it's wet. You're back inside your own 10-yard line. You're in a close football game. You certainly don't want to commit a turnover here.
Line of scrimmage now is the 8-yard line of Rutgers, and they're in dangerous range as you look at Dick Anderson in the middle of your screen, former offensive coordinator at Penn State, a protege of Joe Paterno's. Well, he would have loved to have won the game last week, I can tell you that. He'll get lots of cracks at Penn State before it's over. And they stay on the ground to Smith for a yard or two. That's all he can wedge out, and maybe a wise decision. Actually, he wedged out about five. He just took that whole pile and pushed it backward.
Pretty good second effort.
Not bad at all.
Now let's take a look at what Rutgers is doing inside to Mike Ruth. There's one man, there's two men. A little bit of help from number 73, Tony Rigoli, in there at left tackle. So that's 3-on-1. I'd say the odds are even, wouldn't you?
Yeah, that's about it. That does even it up. Rutgers now will be punting from their own end zone. Matt O'Connell, number six, standing in his end zone. And he is kicking to Kelvin Martin, one of the most dangerous punt return men in the entire nation. He is stationed right on the 50-yard line. Here comes a rush. And a good punt. End over end. And O'Connell, or rather, Martin called for a fair catch. And there was nobody around. However, he had no blockers in his defense. He knew that Boston College was going for the block.
Well, they were all coming at O'Connell. And he got the ball away. And it was not very high. Martin did have a real opportunity to return the football. And I think what happened there is he put his hand up. He called for the fair catch before he saw the situation. And afterwards, he might have had second thought.
Could have kicked himself. From the 50-yard line now, Darren Flutie is split wide to the left. Single setback is Stratford. And Halloran turns and gets to Troy for a couple of yards to the 47-yard line of Rutgers. Stopped by Tyrone Stowe. You'll hear that name on the Rutgers defense as often as we call Mike Ruth's number on the Boston College defense. Stowe is just an outstanding linebacker. 6'2", 225 junior. He's got another year left.
Rutgers defensively has looked good so far in this football game. They're coming with the rush when they can. They're playing the run well. And they know that Halloran's going to throw the football 30, 40 times in this game.
You know, the fact of the matter is, Bruce, they have played well all year. They have just been vulnerable to the big play, that's all.
They've played well and against stiff competition.
From the I formation, second down seven for Sean Halloran and company. And now they go to split backs. A little rollout, he throws against the grain. A good catch at the 40-yard line by Sean Murphy, number 89. They've got three tight ends. And they came with Murphy, number 89, the 6'3 senior. And he went high to snare it and bring it down at the 36 or 37-yard line. They spotted on the 38.
BC has shared the wealth offensively, throwing the football, coming into today's game. 104 passes were thrown, 35 caught by tight ends like this man, Sean Murphy, 38 by wideouts, 31 by backs. So that's great distribution offensively when you're throwing the ball.
Big hit by Gene Austin, the junior cornerback on the receiver, but it did not prevent the first down, and we have come to the end of the first quarter here at the Meadowlands. BC 3 and Rutgers 3. We'll be right back after this.
Sound.
Sounds good to me. Sounds good to me.
Long John Silver's got battered fried shrimp, breaded shrimp, scallops, clams, even oysters.
Sounds like a taste in a place I wanna be. Sounds good, sounds great. Come on, grab me a plate.
Long John Silver.
Sounds good to me.
Call this toll-free number to get in on a special half-price offer. The Sporting News delivered straight to your mailbox every week at a hefty savings.
You'll get the latest lowdown and the hottest showdown. The facts, the quotes, the trends, the draft. All through the NFL season, on to the playoffs and the Super Bowl.
Call toll-free 1-800-826-8080. You pay in three easy installments of only $4.96 each. Call now 1-800-826-8080. That's 1-800-826-8080.
At your dealers now.
Do you know which of these oils gives you the best engine protection under the toughest driving conditions, sub-zero cold or blazing heat? This one, Mobil 1. Now, Mobil 1 and our other fine motor oils come in this easy-pour, resealable plastic container. Mobil Motor Oil. Now it's easier to use than ever.
With Bruce Beck, this is Sam Nover at the Meadowlands in East Rutherford, New Jersey, starting second quarter action here on TCS Sports. It's our Eastern game of the week, and on first down, the give is to Stratford. He steps out of bounds at the 36-yard line. He was stopped again by Tyrone Stowe after picking up a couple of yards. There wasn't much there for him unless he wanted to stick his head into a couple of feet along the sideline.
Here's Stratford. He missed the last three football games with a hamstring injury, and he's just getting back today. And you can see Rutgers with that big pass play, the 53-yard completion to Brian Cobb, with most of their yards in the air in that first quarter, but relatively close.
It is second down and eight now for Boston College and the Rutgers 36, and Halloran, play-action pass. He's had time to throw it today. Has a man, and it's off his fingertips. As Rutgers converts in the secondary. Intended for Darren Flutie, but number two, Darryl Brittingham, and Gene Austin, number 26, a very active cornerback, combined for the double coverage, and the pass was overthrown nonetheless.
We talked about Brittingham earlier today, and on that particular play, he showed his size and also his ability to play heads-up football, think on his feet back there, and he has to at that position in the secondary.
BC has not converted third downs very well today at all. They've got a third and seven here. Halloran arches one for the end zone, and it is caught! Touchdown, Boston College! What a brilliant throw and catch! At the receiving end, Kelvin Martin, number 82.
Touchdown pass. Kelvin Martin, who has great speed. The flanker from Jacksonville, Florida. His fifth touchdown reception of the year. Let's watch it. Deserves another look. Halloran play action. Back deep is Brittingham. Also back there is Twombly, but the ball is just thrown over the head of Twombly. Perfect throw. Excellent execution and 6 points.
Flutie will hold for the extra point. David Rooney will attempt the placement by Flutie, and the kick is up. And it is perfect, and so we have our first touchdown here in the early seconds of the second quarter. And what an electrifying play it was indeed. 35 yards, Halloran right on the money. It's BC 10, Rutgers 3. We'll be back after this.
Make every meal a natural success. Begin with Rocca's Gourmet Pasta. Made with durum, semolina, wheat flour, and whole eggs, and frozen for freshness. Rocca's tortellini with cheese or meat filling is deliciously different. Homemade pasta's never been so easy. Add the goodness and quality of Odenwald fruits and Maliko vegetables. Odenwald is an orchard of fine fruits, hand-picked and perfectly preserved in their naturally light juices. Maliko vegetables are harvested at the peak of flavor and quick-packed to capture that farm freshness.
Choose from the full line of Daly's cocktail mixes at your favorite store.
Fifth touchdown reception of the year for that young man, Kelvin Martin. Eighth touchdown pass by his quarterback, Sean Halloran. Here it is again, Bruce.
Rutgers is back in excellent coverage. You have Brittingham back there. You have Twombly back there. But it's just the speed of Kelvin Martin. Twombly tried to throw the arm up and deflect the ball. The ball comes over his arm, and Martin is there to run it down.
David Rooney, the freshman, has the ball on the kicking tee, and in the receiving spots, Albert Smith, number 33, and Matt Prescott, number 29. It's 10-3 BC. Trying to go 3-3 on the year. Rutgers looking for its first victory of the season. At the goal line, here comes Smith. 15, wedges his way up to the 20-yard line. Rooney helped on the tackle. Number one, Joe Giaquinto, was there to assist on the tackle, along with Willie Hislop, and there's your scoring drive.
So BC mixes it up with passes and runs, 50 yards, and Halloran to Martin for the final damage. This young man is getting better and better. 55% completion percentage on the year. Today, just under 50%, but he's got that touchdown. And you know what else is real important? He's cut down on his interceptions. He's thrown only two in the last two and a quarter games.
He has a chance to redeem himself from a rather mediocre kickoff classic here at the Meadowlands. He liked it better the second time around. This pass is intercepted at the 40-yard line. Badly underthrown by Gagliardi. Ted Gaffney picked it off, but actually Gaffney was a beaten man. The receiver had a couple of steps on him, Brian Cobb, and Gagliardi underthrew him, and Boston College has the ball back again at Rutgers' 41-yard line.
Well, the Eagles come up with another break. Gagliardi, there's his primary receiver. There's number two. He decides to throw it to him. He was out there, and this one just slipped off the arm, and Gaffney drops and comes up with his first interception of the season. Teddy Gaffney, 6'2 senior, DePaul High School, nearby Wayne, New Jersey, playing before some home folks today.
From the 41-yard line of Rutgers in the I formation, Halloran back to pass again. A little flare pass out. Stratford at the 40, cuts it back to the 35-yard line. I beg your pardon, it was Steve Williams, number 2, and not Stratford. It was number 2 instead of number 23, and they pick up 7 yards on the play. Williams is a sophomore out of Providence, Rhode Island. They move some offensive people in and out. Let us pause 5 seconds for station identification. This is the TCS Sports Television Network. With 14:04 to go first half, Sam Nover and Bruce Beck at the Meadowlands in East Rutherford, New Jersey. Boston College leading Rutgers 10-3, and BC has a chance again. Williams in motion and Halloran back to pass. Again, but this one is defended beautifully by Rutgers. That almost was too obvious. The penalty marker is down. Lou Morrow had that one diagnosed as the pass went to Kelvin Martin. However, there is a penalty marker down.
This is what you're looking for from your strong safety. Lou Morrow getting the start today. Jack LaFrere, who started last week, is out for the season with an injury. You come up, you diagnose the play, you stick that head in there, and you come up with a stop. Good football. Good sound, fundamental football.
And waiting now for our referee, Mr. Bauer, Raymond Bauer, to walk off a 15-yard clipping penalty, I believe, against Boston College. We'll set it all the way back to the 50-yard line. So it's second down, but it's now 19 yards to go for Boston College, all the way back at the 50-yard line. And they have twin receivers set to the left from the I formation. Gia Quinto is in there, and so is number 19, Chuck Gregory. Halloran, here's the rush, delivers a football over the middle, and it is almost intercepted. Sitting back there and playing center field was Will Dunster, number 20, and he just watched Halloran all the way and had the best beat on the football, to be honest with you.
Rutgers got pretty good pressure that time from Alec Hope, the left end, who is really the rushing end, while Jim Fickell, the right end, is really the drop-back end. And as you said, Will Dunster dropping back. Will Dunster is the nickel back. When they go to 5 defensive backs, they'll go with Dunster.
Here comes Gia Quinto out wide to the left from the I formation. And they stay on the ground this time, and they give it off to Giles for a few yards to the 47. So Jack Bicknell goes to conservative football. They booed Anderson earlier in this game, Bruce. And now on third and long, Bicknell stays on the ground. He'll be content to play field position football. And as far as he's concerned, hopefully pin Rutgers deep in their own end.
Rutgers defensively doing a fine job that time. Let's see what the Rutgers offense will do. Steve Beach, a seasoned punter, back again for another season.
Getzendanner went off with his arm hanging limp at his side. We'll get a report on him, hopefully. High punt, fair catch at the 14-yard line, and Dunster has it for Rutgers, and so that's where they will get the ball. So no damage following the interception. There's a timeout. It is still Boston College 10, Rutgers 3. We'll be back after this.
.500 very lucky people are going to own a 1986 Parkway Oldsmobile for very little money, because we're selling 500 Oldsmobiles at incredibly low prices this month. For instance, this 1986 Oldsmobile 98 Regency Sedan for $14,995. This 1986 Oldsmobile Cutlass Supreme Coupe for $9,995. Or this 1986 Sierra for $9,995. After you visit Parkway Olds, you'll say,
I got my way at Parkway Olds.
Jersey Central Power and Light Company, striving to serve your needs 24 hours a day, every day of the year. Supplying dependable electricity to homes, businesses, public institutions, and cities in its service area. Jersey Central, developing energy conservation programs that are important to its customers and to the future of our country. Jersey Central, service is our business.
Jack Bicknell enjoying a 10-3 lead at the moment. Rutgers has the ball now. Joe Gagliardi, the quarterback. And they begin at their own 14-yard line. Short drop. And he throws it out, and it's trapped at the 20-yard line. Incompleted pass intended for Roy Hoover, number 36. But again, Gagliardi a little bit short of his intended receiver.
Rutgers going with three wide receivers in that play, trying to open things up offensively a little bit. Now they get their second tailback back in the game. And they send Roy Hoover, the third wide receiver, back to the bench.
And Jack McNeil making the proper defensive changes, too. Twin receivers to the left. In the slot is Brian Cobb, and they give it straight ahead, and Prescott is ripped down, shy of the line of scrimmage. He ran into somebody on the far side, may have been Romanowski, the big linebacker it was, and Billy decked him right at the 13-yard line and really ripped him to the ground.
Romanowski comes up from his linebacker position here. Just watch.
Ooh.
Could you hear it?
I felt it, which is even worse.
Here's another look. Watch Romanowski. The key here is great pursuit. He gets off the football in a hurry, comes up in that linebacker position. He's 3 or 4 yards set back in the line, and he still makes the pop on Prescott. And Matt Prescott giving away some 35 pounds there. Had to have felt that one.
Third down and 11 now for the Scarlet Knights back at their 13-yard line. They have a wing to the right and Gagliardi on a quick count. Has some time, and the pass is knocked right back into his face. Number 95, Chuck Gorecki, slapped it down. The senior out of Paoli, Pennsylvania, 6'3", 232. And there is an injured Rutgers player down on the ground. Check that one out. I believe that's number 73, Tony Rigoli, who is being attended to at the 7-yard line.
Watch Gorecki get the arm up, and he really knocked down that football. Gorecki's second fine play of the day.
And you can see Rigoli go down in that pile, too, trying to pass protect. And Tony is still being attended to. It's fourth down, and Rutgers will punt it away again. And guess what? Boston College is going to get some good field position again.
Boston College played solid defense in that last series. Really, for the game, but BC is playing well defensively. Rigoli, by the way, is the backup left or right tackle from Hauppauge, New York. He's a senior, has played the years with Rutgers.
You know, Bruce, while you're handing out plaudits, you might start with the Rutgers defense, and I'll tell you what. We were in this position just moments ago when they had to kick it. O'Connell had to kick the ball from his own end zone, and they held. They got the ball back again through the interception, and they held. They've got the ball back, and they're going to have to try to hold again. And the defense of Rutgers saved the one touchdown pass, which was magnificently thrown by Halloran against double coverage. The Rutgers defense has played extremely well in this game.
And they have throughout the season. They've just given up some big plays. And once again today, there's not much you can do when a Kelvin Martin blazing runner on the right sideline does a fly pattern and the ball is there.
Here's O'Connell from his goal line. And Martin awaiting the punt at the 50. Low snap, and he got it away. At the 49 of Rutgers, Martin to the 45 and a good tackle in the open field. Jim Pickell, number 97, is the man who made the stop. But again, Boston College gets the ball in plus territory. There's a timeout on the field. BC leads it 10-3. We'll be back after this.
Sounds good to me. Sounds good to me.
Long John Silver's got batter fried shrimp, breaded shrimp, scallops, clams, even oysters.
Sounds like a taste in a place I want to be. Sounds good. Sounds great. Come on, grab me a plate. Long John Silver. Sounds good to me.
Of Daly's cocktail mixes at your favorite store.
11:45 to go in the first half. Boston College with the ball at Rutgers' 45-yard line with a single setback behind the quarterback, Sean Halloran. He's got one touchdown pass today to Kelvin Martin. He gives it to Bell, the fullback, and he barrels his way inside the 40 to the 39-yard line. A gain of 6 yards on the play by the fullback, number 24, Ken Bell, a senior out of Greenwich, Connecticut. At 5'10", 189, Pickell made the stop. That is Pickell as in George.
Field position definitely a factor in this first half. Boston College last three possessions starting from a 50, 41, and 45. Rutgers last three possessions from their own 14, 15, and 20.
Here we go from the 39-yard line. Second down and four. And it's Bell again. And he wedges his way inside the 35-yard line to a first down for Boston College. He's tackled there by Tony Sagnella, number 78, the senior out of Hamden, Connecticut. And so Boston College, having had success on only one drive now through the air, will elect to stay on the ground.
Rutgers has to remember Bell from last year. He had a 92-yard kickoff return for a touchdown, sticking his head in there today from the fullback position and picking up yardage.
Gieselman has yet to catch a pass today. They're big tight end, but they've got three of them, all of whom are dangerous. High formation. On the pitch, Williams cuts it back inside the 30 to the 25-yard line. Very close to another Boston College first down. And so now the Eagles have elected to stay on the ground and have found success running it three straight times for two first downs.
They're winning the battle of the trenches right now. That front five, reaching Ostrowski, Twomley, Trapillo, and Wydell just really blocking out here. And a good cutback by Steve Williams.
Inside a block by Ostrowski. First down at the 24-yard line, and here come the Eagles again, leading 10-3. Allerin out over his center. Darren Twomley. Mark Gowetzki has a broken nose and did not play or did not start. Bell wedging his way for 2 or 3 yards. And he's thrown back by Stowe and a cast of thousands. Gain of 3 or 4, maybe. Second down now, Boston College. And this entire drive, which began at the 45 of Rutgers, has been on the ground.
And this is unusual for Boston College, a team that's thrown the football 40 times in a game. They have gotten back their tailbacks today in Stratford, Steve Williams, and Tyrone Taylor. Let's see what they do here on second and six.
At the 20-yard line, Halloran running the option. And he pitches it off to Williams. Stop and go, and he got inside the 15 and may have another first down for Boston College. An excellent move by Steve Williams, the young sophomore, who stopped for a moment and then put it in high gear and headed for the sidelines and picked up a BC first down at the 13-yard line. So Rutgers defense, forced to be on the field for much of this first half, will have to stiffen here.
The word they use to describe Jack Bicknell's offense is multiple, and you can understand why. For the first time today, we saw the option play with the quarterback executing to the outside. He shows a great deal of motion, a great deal of movement, and he'll alternate players in and out of the football game quite often.
Giles gets the handoff to the 10, the 9-yard line. A gain of 4, second down and 6, and I think you hit the nail on the head, Bruce. That Boston College with the bigger offensive line against the undersized Rutgers defensive front, simply just hammering away and running the ball very effectively.
This front five is one of the biggest in the East, and they have been for the last 4 or 5 years. They go 281, 271, 265, 275, 285 up front.
Keith Quinto is wide to the right, and Kelvin Martin to the left on second down and 6. Now Martin in motion, passing in front of your screen to pitch. To the 5, to the 3, to the ball carrier Steve Williams, who has been on this entire series giving Troy Stratford a rest, and they have found themselves quite a tailback here in this young sophomore. He is very close to another Boston College first down inside the 5.
DC playing it on the ground, something's working for you, might as well continue to exploit it. Look at Williams. Hit that head in there. Hey, he knocked a couple people down.
Jim Fecal is one of them who fell under the onslaught of young Steve Williams. It is third down and less than a yard. He is shy of the sticks. Halloran brings him out again. And he gives his time to Giles, and he's knocked down at the 5-yard line. An excellent defensive play by Tony Sagnella, who met the ball carrier head on. And let's see whether Jack Bicknell now will take the 3 or go on fourth down. He's got fourth and now maybe 2 yards.
Watch Sagnella, 78, McIver, 99. The two of them converging on the ball carrier. Rutgers with a fine defensive play. On fourth down now, they'll have to decide to go or keep the football. And look at that hit. Now, you can talk about moving the football as long as you want, but when you get down to those crucial third down plays and you come up with an effort like that, you have to feel good.
And they have forced Boston College to attempt the field goal. David Rooney will attempt the 20-yarder. Rooney puts it down, kick is up, and it's just like an extra point for the young freshman, who is 2-for-2 today in the field goal department after going 1 out of 5. But it's a moral victory for the Scarlet Knights. They kept Boston College out of the end zone. There's a timeout with BC leading 13-3. We'll be back after this.
General asks, are you buying yesterday's technology? Data General, computer systems so advanced, we win more major contracts than any other company. Data General.
World-class tennis comes to Meadowlands Arena October 8th and 9th with a possible rematch of the U.S. Open Tennis Finals. Can John McEnroe avenge his loss to Yvonne Lendl? Booming serves, slashing returns, rapid-fire volleys. As Lendl, McEnroe, Jimmy Connors, and Andre Gomez showcase their talent in the members-only Meadowlands Tennis Challenge. Be part of the celebrity-studded audience October 8th and 9th at the Meadowlands Arena. Tickets at the box office and Ticket World.
Sam Noper and Bruce Beck back at the Meadowlands here with Boston College leading 13-3, and we were just talking during the timeout. This Rutgers defense has prevented what could have been a BC runaway early on in this ballgame. They have kept Rutgers in the game.
BC was running the football well. They picked up 3 first downs exclusively by using the run, and all of a sudden Rutgers defensively came up with that one big play when they had to force the field goal. Now they've got to turn to the offense and say, hey, fellas, help us out.
Albert Smith and Matt Prescott await this kick by Rooney. And it's 5 yards, it's 9 yards deep, almost out of the field of play. And so the youngster demonstrates a great leg, the freshman out of Miramar, Pennsylvania. As you look at the scoring drive that resulted in just 3, I'm sure Jack McNeil would like to have had, much preferred to have the touchdown.
You've got to be saying, wow, that's strange. 8 plays, 8 runs for Boston College. I thought this was a passing team. Well, they found they could run and run effectively, especially to the left in that last drive. And don't tamper with success.
Jack McNeil scratching his head a bit, wondering how he can move so well in the middle of the field, but having difficulty down in close. Here's Joe Gagliardi now with a chance to get Rutgers back in the football game. They flop their tight end, number 89, Bruce Campbell. And Gagliardi, play action pass, has a man wide open, throws it, it's caught at the 42-yard line. He had too many could have chosen between number 89, Campbell, and number 36, Roy Hoover. They were looked like a two-on-one fast break, 22 yards on the completed pass. He could have had either one of them.
Now, this is vintage Gagliardi. He rolls out. He has good vision. Wide open receiver is Bruce Campbell, who had his bell rung last week against Penn State, had a mild concussion, was questionable for today's game, but he's in there, and he picked up the first down yardage.
From the 41-yard line, here comes Rutgers. And the handoff on a delay to the 42, and stumbling his way and fumbling the ball is Smith, and Boston College is recovered. Albert Smith running with the football. It was fighting for the extra yardage. And how many times have you seen it? He was hit at the line of scrimmage, had gotten himself another 3 or 4 yards, fumbled the ball, and BC has it.
Breaks are going the way of Boston College. A little bit of a delay. Watch Prescott stick his head in there. Here comes Smith. He just loses the football, and the Eagles come up with it. Let's watch it again. Albert Smith, who is playing fullback again today for the first time in a long while, never really had the football, did he? Pops out. Didn't seem to have a good feel for it. Eagles are there.
Andy Hemmer flopped down the football at the 43-yard line of Rutgers, and here are the Eagles again in bus territory. Gain of about 3 by Steve Williams, who tried to cut it back. Stowe is trying to bring that Rutgers defense alive.
This is easy, isn't it? Just look for 41.
Yes, that's right. There's a happy Hemmer.
The BC has good depth at the linebacker spot. Hemmer playing for Gaffney at one linebacker came up with that last play, and Galvin behind Romanowski gives BC good depth at the other linebacker position.
And a bad break for Rutgers. They have been hit with a personal foul penalty here, and so the walk-off will be 15 yards to the 25-yard line, and Boston College will have it first down and 10 to go. So the Eagles, who have had opportunities for a blowout, are in that situation again. It is first down and 10 to go, Boston College, at the Rutgers 25-yard line. Seems like they've lived down here on this end of the field for an eternity. 6:51 to go, second quarter. Boston College 13 and Rutgers 3. And the Scarlet Knights defense, scrappy, undersized, trying to hang on for dear life. Halloran with all day to throw the football. Still has all day. And down he goes at the 33-yard line, and again, it's that man Tyrone Stowe. But credit the secondary of Rutgers. They did a magnificent job of protecting against the pass.
You can talk all you want about the offensive line in this play, giving Halloran ample protection. But you're right, Sam. You got to look at that secondary. Twomley, Morrow, Brittingham, Austin, they're all back there for an eternity. If you're a receiver here, you just try to break free. You try to break off and look for the open man. Look at this blocking. Look at the time. But finally, Halloran runs out of time and runs into Tyrone Stowe.
Second down, 17 now for BC. On a delay. And a couple of yards is all that the ball carrier gets. Steve Williams and penalty markers fly all over the place as he reaches the 30-yard line in the grasp of Tony Sagnella. But penalty markers are down. And the preliminary indication is against Rutgers.
And I believe it was in the secondary.
Might have some holding in the secondary. It's a crazy game to figure out. Boston College figured to throw the ball effectively against Rutgers. They have not thrown the ball well at all, except for the one scoring strike to Martin. They figured to be able to run a lot better. They have they figured not to be able to run the ball, and they've won it fairly well.
And it's holding in the secondary against Rutgers. Rutgers is hurting themselves. It's that simple, Sam. They're committing turnovers, and they're coming up with untimely penalties.
And the infraction is walked off from the point of the infraction, and so actually it becomes an 11-yard penalty. They were in second and 17. They're now in second down and 6. And it was only a 5-yard walk-off. So here we go now from the 21-yard line.
Not an automatic first down defensive holding.
Halloran sprints to his right, looking in the end zone. Down he goes to the 25.
Pope got him. Alec Pope came from his left end position, put the pressure on Halloran. And once again, this defense coming up with big, big plays in tough situations. Watch the left side of your screen. 69, Alec Pope. And he snuck around to the outside and comes up behind Halloran and nails him.
So we're back to the original line of scrimmage after all of this craziness. It is third down and 10 now for BC, and Halloran has had all day to throw the ball, has found nobody open, now drops back into a shotgun formation. Takes a direct snap.
Good.
The rush is on. Delivers the ball, and it's intercepted by Rutgers at the 25. And a flag is down. Matt Backman reached up, the junior linebacker, and pulled it out of the air.
I think you're going to see holding on the offensive team in the center of the line. Rutgers came with the blitz, and they really put the pressure on Halloran. He shouldn't have thrown the football. Nobody was there. Now here's the play again. Bachman 59 blitzing. Stowe coming around to his left side blitzing. Pressure is there. Halloran just throws it away. The closest man to where he threw the football is an offensive lineman. And unfortunately, he threw a ball here which he shouldn't have. And Rutgers comes up with the interceptor. Wow, that's great hands considering that Bachman was blitzing on the play.
Started the blitz and must have curled back into a pass protection and got the football. Here's Gagliardi from his 25, rolling hard to the left and delivers the ball on the money, and it's dropped on the far side of the field. Intended for Roy Hoover, and it was right on his hip as he hit the out-of-bounds marker, and he dropped the ball. But you can't ask for a better one, but it was not Gagliardi's fault.
So the Rutgers defense has presented the offense with the opportunity to do something here. They've come up with big plays time and time again.
It is incredible how the Rutgers defense has kept this team in the game from the 26-yard line. Five defensive backs now for Boston College, anticipating Gagliardi's pass. He's got an eye formation set behind him, and he gives it to Prescott for about 6 yards. Running hard with the ball is Matt Prescott, the sophomore, out of Willingboro, New Jersey. And he picked up 6. It'll be third down and 4. He goes down in the grasp of Carl Creshpain and Carl Pellegata in the secondary.
Pretty good trap here by Rutgers. One of their better running plays of the afternoon. Prescott, by the way, came into camp as a freshman but had a motorcycle accident before the season, broke his collarbone in his arm, missed all of last season. Here he is as a sophomore. Eligibility-wise, he's a freshman.
Here's Gagliardi with a big third down opportunity. Receivers left and right. Throws it over the middle. Oh, right in and out of the hands of Boston College's linebacker. At the 35-yard line, he'll never have a better opportunity. Number 46, Bill Thompson, the sophomore from Trenton, New Jersey. Oh, look at him put his hands up on his helmet there.
97, Boza putting on the pressure. The pass across the middle, and it was intended for really nobody but Billy Thompson. It was a crossing pattern, but the ball was underthrown. And Kelvin Martin, the dangerous one, the ever-present Kelvin Martin, back in single punt receiving formation.
Matt O'Connell, the freshman out of Bethesda, Maryland, at his 20-yard line. Boston College will have to start deeper this time than they have all day. Martin backpedaling at the 20-yard line. Now turns it upfield, 25 to the 30, and he's pulled down at the 30-yard line. And so a return of 10 yards after that punt that covered 48 yards by young Mr. O'Connell. And so Boston College now gets the ball at their own 30-yard line in a 13-3 football game. This one may be coming back. I see Rutgers moving back. We have a legal procedure against the Scarlet Knights and clipping against Boston College, offsetting penalties. And so O'Connell's going to have to do it again. That's a shame because he got off an excellent punt.
Well, once again, penalty hurting the Scarlet Knights.
From the 32-yard line. And again, referee Bauer indicating the calls of the offsetting penalties against either side. The clock shows 3 minutes and 42 seconds left here in the first half. O'Connell again back and will hit this ball at about his 20-yard line. And Martin stands at the 30. He was driven back to the 20 on the previous punt. Kelvin Martin averaging about 15 yards a return. He's going to let this one bounce, and it takes a Boston College bounce. It's a Rutgers player at the 32-yard line and dies right there. So really, there's very little difference. A 35-yard punt, however, there is no return. And BC will begin its own 32-yard line, leading the game 13-3 over Rutgers and trying to go 3-3 on the year. And Dick Anderson, Scarlet Knights, looking for their first victory of the season.
This is the worst field position BC's had in a long time, and they're at their own 32.
That's right. Out now and sends Darren Flutie in motion. And now Scott Gieselman flops sides and comes strong side to the left. They're going to have to try to confuse Rutgers here to have effective passing. Williams dives to the 34, and that's about it. Steve getting only 2 yards on the carry. Lou Morrow, the senior out of Union City, New Jersey, is the man who came up to make the stop from the strong safety position.
I talked to Vic Nell during the week, and I asked him about the movement. Why are you always moving wide receivers? Why is there always motion? He says, movement neutralizes the defense. We are dictating to them instead of them dictating to us.
It is second down and 8 now for BC. They have the ball spotted right on the 35-yard line. Halloran turns, gives on a misdirection. For about 3 or 4 yards, the ball carrier Tracy Giles, a freshman from Southborough, New Jersey. It'll be third down and 5, and while we have a moment, we want to send along our best wishes to Eleanor Thomas, who is the aunt of our executive producer, Tom Hewitt. She is home from the hospital, and if you're watching us, Eleanor, today, and we know you are, we wish you a speedy recovery. I know your nephew, Tom, has been concerned about you and hope everything goes well for you. From the 38-yard line, it is third down and 4 now. BC trying to sustain a drive, and here we go, reminiscent of that running drive before, Bruce.
Big third down play.
Will Halloran put it up on top? Stays downstairs to Bell and gets the first down. To the 44-yard line, the big fullback, Ken Bell, running with the ball, stopped by Matt Backman. But BC again successful, staying down on the ground.
This is ball control football that they're trying to put together here in the first half. And the reason it's important now is because we're inside of 2:30 in the first half. They don't want to give Rutgers the football back. And if they can eat up the clock and keep moving the football, well, they have to feel good about things.
From the 44-yard line, Troy Stratford.
And we hear he may be done for the day.
Yes, yep. Indeed. He has gotten out of his clothes and into civvies. He tried to go in this football game. We have a timeout here as Halloran calls BC's first timeout of the half. Troy ran effectively in the first quarter. Didn't carry the ball all that often. Was used as a receiver a couple of times. Carried it five times for 20 yards. But they don't want to risk any further damage to him.
A hamstring is a tough, tough thing to recover from. I know I have one right now. You just can't seem to get back. Every time you get close, something else happens, and it's a shame because Stratford against Rutgers has had some big, big football games in 82, 132 yards rushing, in 83, 116, and last year before he was injured, 44 yards rushing and 44 in the air.
We want to invite you, Shirley, to stay tuned at halftime. Bruce has a very interesting interview with Brett Gruninger, the athletic director at Rutgers, and I think you'll find it most interesting. Sam Dover and Bruce Beck, we are at the Meadowlands here in East Rutherford, New Jersey, as you look at Dick Anderson trying to exhort his defense on and to keep him alive in this football game, and they have thus far in a 13-3 game. Nice to have you with us. We mentioned it had rained furiously earlier in the day. I think we got a nice day for football.
I think we do, and one thing you have to worry about if you're Anderson is that defense has been on the field a long time in this first half. They have to be a little bit tired. He's looking forward to getting that group to the locker room.
And it's a rather humid afternoon, might I add. So here comes Boston College again. They have a first down, a minute 54 with which to work. They send Tyrone Taylor in motion. Halloran on a keeper, 45 to the 50, good fake, and out of bounds to the 47-yard line. Just a quarterback keeper. They faked activity to one end, and Halloran kept the ball and rolled around the left side himself. Quarterback keeper, and Jim Pacal ran him out, but he gained about 8 or 9 yards on it.
Well, they call that a naked bootleg because you're naked out there as the quarterback. Nobody's in front of you to provide the blocking. Halloran made the most of the opportunity, and again, Cowboy Jack Picknell getting things going. That's not Jack.
It's second down and one now from the I formation. Both receivers are split to the right, and Halloran going back to the air. Throws one over the middle, and it's incomplete. Stowe knocked it out of the hands of Scott Gieselman, and what a great secondary the Rutgers Scarlet Knights have had in this football game. Their linebackers, their deep backs have just played so extraordinarily well.
You're right. When you talk about the secondary, you talk about the deep four, but today Rutgers is getting help from the middle two, the inside linebackers, Stowe and Bachman. Bachman had the interception. Stowe, you've seen all over the football field on that play, stopped the pass from going to Scotty Gieselman.
That pass simply wasn't there, Bruce. Great coverage by Stowe. Third down and one. They had a play to give away. Now they got to get the first down, and Halloran's going to throw it again. He's got a man over the middle, and he throws it. It's caught and dropped. The flag is down. Intended for Sean Murphy, the big tight end who may have jumped too soon. But a penalty marker is down. Halloran finally had an open receiver, and the receiver couldn't hold the ball.
A little surprising that they put the ball up there on third and one also.
The discussion, and here's referee Bauer now with the preliminary signal. It is holding against Boston College.
And I think the holding is on 26, Darren Flutie, way downfield. Plenty of time here, wide open receiver. And you're talking about one of their most reliable receivers, Sean Murphy, coming off the bench, steady, and he just dropped the football.
So it's fourth down and one. What do you do here if you're Dick Anderson? I guess he's going to take the penalty. He didn't want to leave it up to Boston College to take fourth down and one.
Hold it. On the offense. 10 yards. Third down.
Well, we're glad we have our referee back with us.
So it's third down 11. I have to assume that Anderson thought Bicknell would go for it from the 45-yard line.
Well, I think Anderson wants field position, wants to get the ball back before halftime, and wants to move the ball, get some points before he can. He'll pick the 10.
A minute 39 to half. Third and 11 for Halloran. Makes the play action. Looking downfield. Flag is down, and he throws the pass intended for Steve Williams through his hands. And that would have been short of the first down nonetheless. But again, a penalty flag is down.
Offensive holding, Boston College.
And this time, Rutgers assuredly will decline it. And they will get the football back with plenty of time to move it downfield and all of their timeouts remaining.
Let's take a look at that offensive line. There's the hold right there on Tony Zagnella. Zagnella was trying to make a move, a holding on the Boston College Eagles. And this time, Rutgers will refuse, as you mentioned, Sam, and they will get the ball back. And here's what Coach Dick Anderson is hoping for, some time and the football.
Boy, it is amazing what this defensive unit has done. They've given up 13 points, but it certainly doesn't show on the scoreboard how well they have played time and again. Peach, good snap, gets a high punt away. Dunster chases the ball over to the sideline, and it goes out of bounds inside the 20. At the 15-yard line, an excellent punt by Mr. Peach, who knocks that ball out of the 15, 38 yards, no return. And Rutgers will begin at their own 14-yard line. They spot it. Downfield. Do you take chances down here?
I think you throw the football. He threw the football last week against Penn State in the late going. Obviously, not as concerned with the time then, but he moved it very well, very quickly. A lot of short passes to the tight ends and backs.
Here's Gagliardi, short dropping over the middle. Throws it downfield. It's caught at the 35-yard line. Prescott out of the backfield, and the linebacker never turned around. Chasing him downfield, I believe, is Ted Gaffney. He never turned around and looked for the football. And so Rutgers gets out of trouble in a hurry.
And watch Gagliardi look for his back coming out of the backfield. Prescott puts it right on the money, and Rutgers is moving quickly now. 7 for 12 for Gagliardi now in the afternoon.
24 yards on that play, and here he goes again. And this one is short of the intended receiver. Again, he was trying to get the ball to Prescott. It stops the clock with a minute 17 to play in the half.
Gagliardi is best in short passing situations, and as I mentioned earlier in today's telecast, he has good vision. He has an ability to look for number one, then he looks for number two, and then he'll find number three, and oftentimes that's a running back. Rutgers would like to get the ball in the wide receiver's hands more often. So far this year, only 10 passes have been caught by wide receivers. That's not enough.
And they've got four receivers who have virtually no game experience before this season began. Second down, 10, Prescott in motion, and Gagliardi back to pass again. Joe delivers it, and it's almost intercepted. In and out of the hands of the linebacker, Bill Romanowski, and that may have been 6 points. That's twice today that a Boston College flag is down, that a BC linebacker has had the ball, had his mitts on the football, but couldn't bring it in.
Well, maybe they should spend some more time on the tip drill and maybe just running pass patterns with those guys.
Clock stopped again with a minute 13. And the preliminary sign is holding, and I think it's against Rutgers. If declined, it'll be third down and 10, but it's going to be accepted to make it second down and 20 at the 28-yard line. Here's referee Bowers.
I think it's fair to say that Gagliardi...
Second down.
Has been behind his receivers throughout much of the first half.
Yes, I think that would be an accurate statement. Joe brings him out, sends two receivers to the top of your screen and one to the left. Actually, they're out of your picture. He's got one set back behind him on second down and 20. Mike Ruth has been kept silent for a moment. Here's the home run ball downfield, and it is incomplete. And no flag, and the Rutgers people want one. It was intended for Greg Rapelli, the junior out of Vincentown, New Jersey. He was screaming for one, but he didn't get it. McPherson was defending there.
Pretty good coverage back there. Jarrett McPherson and Carl Pellegata. Again, Gagliardi sprinting out, scrambling around. Let's see. I really don't think so. That ball was not catchable at all. If anything, it's incidental, and incidental is not a penalty here. He's running for the ball. They're both running into each other. I don't think that ball is catchable, and it's incidental contact.
Third down and 20 from the Rutgers 28-yard line. If BC can stop them here, they'll have a chance again. They've got two timeouts left. Gagliardi downfield again, and this one is intercepted by Boston College. Back to the 45. Spinning to the 50-yard line with the football, and still on his feet at the 45. And dragged down, Garrick McPherson. With the interception, the sophomore from Baltimore, who we talked about just a moment ago. 15 yards on the return, and another penalty flag is down. This one all the way back in the 20-yard line of Rutgers.
And the penalty is holding against the Rutgers offensive line. That will be refused. Boston College, with 52 seconds left in this first half, has another opportunity to score.
Garrick McPherson coming down with the interception. That is his second of the season. And Boston College now might have the last say of the first half.
Gagliardi going up top, looking long for Cobb. McPherson there, the young man from Baltimore, for the second interception of the year, and a pretty good return, 15 yards.
We are back live at the 43-yard line of Rutgers. Boston College in possession. From the I formation, it's Williams to the 40, and 6-10 to the 39, fumbles the ball. Fumbles the ball. Are they going to allow it? No, they say the play was dead. Boston College had called timeout. Sean Halloran coming over to talk to Jack McMill. And so the fumble is not allowed, and it's just inside the 40-yard line of Rutgers.
Well, the brakes are going Boston College's way.
Dick Anderson on the sideline. Boy, if I were Dick Anderson, here's Garrett McPherson accepting the congratulations of his teammate. Boy, I'd go in at halftime and just tell my defense they played spectacularly, and I verbally beat the daylights out of the offense, I can tell you that. Zach Nallen now being helped off the field. He may be the biggest defensive lineman Rutgers has, too. They are an undersized defensive unit, Bruce, as we've said a number of times.
I think so, and Jerry Peter Kuski, who works with that defensive line, says he must be the most dominant player up front for that defensive group to be successful. Well, you still have a lot of time, 44 seconds, and we've seen a lot of things happen in this first half. The Eagles with a comfortable lead. You know they want more points, though. And Rutgers' best offense sometimes has been their defense. Here's Jerry Peter Kuski wearing the headphones with Dick Anderson. Ed O'Neill, who also works with the linebackers and the outside ends defensively.
Scott Gieselman, I don't believe, has caught a pass today, has he, Charlie? He is one catch away from being the third all-time receiver in BC history. Passing Gerard Phelan. Halloran back to pass. Throws one wide open at the 25-yard line, and out of bounds is number 82, Kelvin Martin. First down, Boston College, now in field goal range, and a flag is down again.
I think this one's going to come back. It's on the Eagles for holding.
Preliminary signal is indeed holding against Boston College. What a crazy first half this has been. 13-3, BC leads it if you've just joined it.
There's the hole right there on nose man George McKell. And I believe both Twombly and Trapillo were guilty.
Second down.
Well, if you're going to hold, you might as well have two guys hold. You don't have to give up 20 yards.
Twice as much enjoyment for one penalty. One of the rare times today that a BC receiver has been wide open. And Kelvin Martin was, and certainly that would have put Rooney in field goal range. But they're now back at the 50-yard line. Martin goes out wide to the right, and Darren Flutie to the left. Halloran has had a very difficult time getting the ball through the air to his receivers today. He goes back to pass on 2nd and 16. Avoids a rush. 45. Big fella cuts it back at the 40 to the 39-yard line. And goes down in the grasp of Doug Kukowski, sophomore from Cleveland, Ohio. And Halloran, I believe, has to use another timeout here to stop the clock with 26 seconds to play. It is third down as you look at David Rooney on the sideline. It'll be third down and I would guess about 6 or 7 now for BC to keep the ball.
Halloran is only 5 for 14, 62 yards in the air in this first half. This Rutgers defense has been on the field forever. Can't wait to see the time of possession statistic at halftime.
You're talking about a quarterback, too, who has had 4 straight 200-yard plus passing games. And at least one touchdown pass in all of those games. Of course, he's continued that streak today with the 35-yarder to Martin. When you subtract the 35-yarder to Martin from his stats, he has had a bad day. And the Rutgers secondary has been like the New York Giants secondary. I can tell you that.
Unofficially, time of possession in this first half, about 18 minutes for BC and 11 for Rutgers. So that's a pretty decisive advantage.
26 seconds to play in the half. Third down, 7 for Boston College at the Rutgers 40-yard line. I would guess they're going to have to, I don't know what David Rooney's range is, but I would imagine, even think about a field goal, they're going to have to pick up the first down or get it very close to the sticks, the 32 or 33, for the young man to attempt a field goal inside of 50.
I think you're right. He's only 2 for 6 on the year. Actually, 3 for 7.
3 for 7.
Now, I did 2 today.
2 for 2 today.
But they were both chippy.
So Halloran comes back now to the huddle, having taken the instructions from his head coach, Jack McNeil. Martin is at the top of your screen to the right. The clock is inserted for you. Halloran can't find anybody. Over the middle, caught, not a first down at the 33-yard line.
Good hit by Bachman.
Ken Bell made the reception. Bachman made the stop on him. And on fourth down, here comes Rooney rushing on the field. They've got 9 seconds to get the play off.
It'll be about 52 yards.
They've got 5 seconds to get the play off. They've got 2 seconds to get it off. They won't get it off. The half has come to an end. As Boston College had utilized all of their timeouts, they rushed their kick team on the field, and they could not get the kick in time. Well, the snap from the first half has come to an end. A most interesting first half, to say the least. The score is Boston College 13 and Rutgers 3. We'll be back with our halftime activities right after this.
.500 very lucky people are going to own a 1986 Parkway Oldsmobile for very little money, because we're selling 500 Oldsmobiles at incredibly low prices this month. For instance, this 1986 Oldsmobile 98 Regency Sedan for $14,995. This 1986 Oldsmobile Cutlass Supreme Coupe for $9,995. Or this 1986 Sierra for $9,995. After you visit Parkway Olds, you'll say,
I got my way at Parkway Olds.
Are you knocking yourself out looking for advertising that works?
Yeah.
You've tried almost everything, right? Newspapers, radio, even direct mail, and you're still not getting results, right?
Right.
Well, cable advertising is the answer. Cable reaches the market and customers your business needs. The channel selection offers you, the advertiser, the media variety to achieve those elusive results. Call TKR Advertising today at 356-1220. We've got the solution.
The score would indicate Rutgers is still very much in this game. David Rooney with a couple of chip shot field goals at 29 and 20 yards. And the one touchdown scored, a 35-yard pass from Halloran to Martin. And that accounts for all 13 of Boston College's points. Tom Engstad has a 27-yard field goal for Rutgers. And thus our halftime score of Boston College 13 and Rutgers 3. We are at halftime in East Rutherford, New Jersey. We'll be back with more of our halftime show right after this.
This is where it all begins, the diagram in the team's playbook. But here's where it really comes together, in Pack Stadium on Sunday afternoon, the game on the line. That, my friend, is the real thing. And when it comes to sports coverage, the real thing for me is right here, the Sporting News.
Call this toll-free number to get in on a special half-price offer. The Sporting News delivered straight to your mailbox every week at a hefty saving.
The Sporting News delivers hard-hitting, close-up action. Stats you just won't find in your local news or anywhere else. On-the-scene coverage of pro and college football, basketball, baseball, hockey, boxing, and more. 52 weeks a year.
Call toll-free 1-800-826-8080. Save one half off the regular subscription rate. You pay in three easy installments of only $4.96 each. Call now, 1-800-826-8080. That's 1-800-826-8080.
Daily's cocktail mixes at your favorite store.
From the Meadowlands in East Rutherford, New Jersey, it is halftime. The Rutgers-Boston College football game. The beautiful facility here of the Meadowlands and Rutgers University, the subject of this particular introspective look.
Modern research facilities and a highly honored faculty are two good reasons students who want an education which looks to the future look to Rutgers. New Jersey's State University provides the specialized courses and the distinctive student life of a smaller college within the larger context of one of America's leading research universities. Rutgers' beginnings go back to colonial days, but it is now a leader in high technology areas such as biotechnology, computer science, and material science. And merit awards and challenging honors courses are available for high-achieving students. With campuses in Camden, Newark, and New Brunswick, Rutgers provides the diversity and excitement you may be looking for. If you're interested in looking to the future, then you should be looking at Rutgers, the State University of New Jersey.
New Jersey is proud to host today's exciting college football game here.
typewriter, get a copy machine, get a new calculator, get it all on sale now from Crazy Eddie. Yes, Crazy Eddie now carries typewriters, copy machines, and calculators, and he's got them all on sale now at the guaranteed lowest sale prices ever. Shop around, get the lowest sale prices you can find, then see Crazy Eddie, and he'll beat them. Crazy Eddie will not be undersold, and that's the Crazy Eddie guarantee. So get a new typewriter, copy machine, calculator, get it all on sale now from Crazy Eddie. Crazy Eddie, his prices are insane.
In 1859, Isaac Cook created a great American champagne to launch the great American clipper ships. Today, Americans are still launching celebrations with Cook's Imperial American Champagne. When your ship comes in, celebrate with Cook's Imperial American Champagne. Percent pure. It floats. For over 100 years, those words have meant ivory. Today, ivory freshens more complexions and helps more people feel clean, look healthy than any other soap. For a natural and pure kind of clean, one soap still rises to the top. Ivory.
Hey, OJ, isn't that Marcus Allen?
Remember when you could do that?
Arnie, I may have lost a step or two, but I can still get through an airport in a hurry.
You mean you still got it?
Yep, right here, the Hertz Express Service Pass. It lets you go directly from your plane to your car without stopping at the terminal counter. There's no faster way out of an airport.
It's him again.
Hey, Marcus, come here. Do I have to teach you everything?
Marcus!
Not everything.
Hertz, the number one way to rent a car.
We're at halftime of our Eastern College football game of the week. We'll be back with more festivities right after this.
I'm at Giant Stadium, East Rutherford, New Jersey. The Scarlet Knights of Rutgers, the Eagles of Boston College. And you know, there's been a lot of excitement at Rutgers University lately, and the man caught in the middle of the excitement is Athletic Director Fred Gruninger, now in his 13th year at the helm of the Banks of the Old Raritan. Fred, tell us about the changes in facilities over the past year or so.
Well, it's very exciting, Bruce. Last year we had an opportunity to add to our facility an outdoor synthetic field with lights, and then also the largest indoor facility complex, air structure complex in the country, which covers the size of a football field, soccer field, plus with the track around the outside. And so certainly this facility, along with the new facility that's going to come to the Rutgers Stadium area, starting this late this winter, fall, will give us what we think is just a tremendous facility complex on the New Brunswick Piscataway campus.
What is that new facility all about? Will it include a weight room? Will there be coaches' quarters and things like that?
Well, there will, Bruce. It'll be a multi-purpose facility. It'll have a primary purpose of being directly related to the needs of the football program, but will serve and augment and supplement the needs of all the other programs that work out of the stadium. Football with a new locker room, a weight training and physical exercise area, which will again be used for all of our sports. We'll have an athletic treatment and care area. We'll have classrooms, we'll have the offices, and we'll have a reception area, which will be used for all of our programs, and will give us the opportunity to really show off our stadium and its new facility.
Now, the viewers watching the game today must be noticing that NJ on the Rutgers helmets. What is New Jersey's relationship with Rutgers University?
Well, Bruce, very simply, we are New Jersey. And that has to be, told many times over. The name of Rutgers University has its tradition, its historical background, has its great academic reputation. And for years, as the state university, we have not really given that forefront that we are one and the same, perfect together. And that's why the New Jersey Rutgers logo is something that we're very proud to see. And the response to it has been excellent.
A lot of intersectional games this year. You take on the University of Tennessee. You've already played Florida and came out very nicely, a 28-28 tie. What is the concept as far as Rutgers scheduling is concerned with the future, keeping in mind the Eastern powers and the intersectional rival?
Well, Bruce, it's a natural for us to continue with our 1A friends here in the Northeast. So the Penn States and the Pittsburghs and the West Virginias and the Syracuse Temple, right on down the line, Boston College, Army, and then eventually Navy in the early 90s, will give us the basis of our future schedule, which will give us eight 1A teams, and we're the ninth in the Northeast. Then we'll take the intersectional fling with a game with the Southeastern Conference. And this year it's unusual. Scheduling, we have Florida and Tennessee, both on the SEC. We'll have a couple of games with the Atlantic Coast Conference people. We have a couple of Big Ten rivals on the docket in the years down the road. Then we'll have the Louisville and the Cincinnati as the independents. So we'll mix and go, and we still have, as someone says, is there anything traditional left to the Rutgers schedule? And on the drawing board, we still have Colgate as one of those traditional games that we hope will continue on for a long time. So that's the Rutgers schedule for the next 10 years.
Now, you talk about mix and go, but when you have Penn State, and you have Pittsburgh, and you have West Virginia, and you have Rutgers, you have Boston College, and other teams, I'm not going to mention everyone, you really have the nucleus of a tremendous Eastern College football conference. I know it's been on the board before. Are there any chances that it will happen in the future?
Well, I think unofficially it's there right now, Bruce, and let's just look at it that way. As far as an official conference or an official football league, I think that's still down the road a little bit. We have a few things to do and a few people to come together to make it all happen, but we're there. We're all playing each other, and I think the rivalry each year begins to grow, and the excitement and the enthusiasm in itself makes us an unofficial conference of the Northeast.
Finally, a comment on the Anderson era. Dick Anderson, now in his second season coming over from Penn State, what he's meant to this program.
Well, I think one of our students said the other day when they came in and talked about where is our program and what are we going to do, and he said, you know, the Anderson era has arrived. It's the most exciting thing that's happened to Rutgers football in a long time. And I'll just take it and let that student's feeling sort of permeate and say that's what our feeling is. It is exciting, and I think it just tells us that what he has done to our program, what he has given our program, and the support that he's getting, which is most important, makes us all believe that we're on the right track.
When you can get a student quote, take it and run.
Fred
Greninger, thanks for stopping by. Continued success for Rutgers University.
Thank you, Bruce.
Halftime at Giant Stadium. More halftime festivities coming up. The Scarlet Knights and the Eagles of Boston College. We'll be back with more after this.
How often does she wish that she was a member of the cheerleading squad on the sidelines? Well, now she can be what she's always dreamed of being, a cheerleader. Get up and cheer. We'll get your young athlete jumping, tumbling, and chanting like never before. This video on the basics of cheerleading features instruction by members of the nationally ranked Penn State cheerleading squad. Get up and cheer has warm-up exercises, gymnastics, partner stunts, and more. For $34.95, order your own copy of Get Up and Cheer. Use your MasterCard or Visa. Call toll-free 800-531-5314 or send check or money order to TCS, Box 11300, 701 Alpha Drive, Pittsburgh 15238. Add $2 for shipping and handling. Pennsylvania residents at 6% sales tax. Give that little cheerleader something to cheer about. Order Get Up and Cheer. Call 800-531-5314.
1414, or send check or money order for $34.95 to TCS, Box 11300, 701 Alpha Drive, Pittsburgh 15238. Allow 6 weeks for delivery.
I know. How does the seafood sound?
Sounds good to me. Sounds good to me.
Long John Silver's got batter-fried shrimp, breaded shrimp, scallops, clams, even oysters.
Sounds like a taste in a place I want to be. Sounds good. Sounds great. Come on, grab me a plate.
Long John Silver.
Sounds good to me.
Call this toll-free number to get in on a special half-price offer. The sporting news delivered straight to your mailbox every week at a hefty saving.
You'll get the latest lowdown and the hottest showdown. The facts, the quotes, the trends, the draft, all through the NFL season on to the playoffs and the Super Bowl.
Call toll-free 1-800-826-8080. You pay in free easy installments of only $4.96 each. Call now 1-800-826-8080. That's 1-800-826-8080.
This game is being brought to you by Daily's Juice Products, who remind you there's a daily treat for everyone. And by Meyer Siegel & Associates, fine family of foods, Odenwald fruits, and no Leco vegetables. When it comes to quality, you can see the difference. And by Long John Silver Seafood Shops. More fish, chicken, and a whole lot more. Long John Silver sounds good to me. Sam Nover back in the Meadowlands. You see our halftime score. BC leading Rutgers by a score of 13-3. We mentioned, if you joined us late, about the rain that came earlier today. We thought for a few minutes, laughingly, we might have an empty stadium here today. About 11:30, there was nobody here. But the crowd has come out, and obviously Rutgers has had their support, and their defense has played splendidly to keep them in the football game. The one touchdown play was a magnificently thrown pass by Halloran. May have been the only good pass he threw in the entire first half.
And it's a straight fly pattern down the right side to Kelvin Martin, the blazer from Jacksonville, Florida. And look at this football. It is thrown extremely well over the outstretched reach of Frittingham and Steve Twomley. Touchdown, Boston College. Only touchdown of the first half. Halloran threw this ball extremely well. Martin used his blazing speed. Rutgers, defensively, I think did about as good a job as they could have under the circumstance. It was just a matter of execution. Boston College had it. Fine throw by Halloran. There's the big play of the first half.
Yeah, one thing you might look for, Jack McNeil obviously knows that his offense has been defended against beautifully as far as the pass is concerned. I think the passes they threw to their running backs were obvious, particularly in the first quarter, went to Stratford, and when Martin came back on a wide receiving screen. I mean, Rutgers was there to defend against him. Halloran's got to throw the ball downfield, and he's got to utilize his tight ends more because Gieselman hasn't caught a pass, and I think Casparello's caught only one pass, and Murphy's caught one. So, you know, where are you if you're not getting the ball to the tight end in a BC offense?
You also have to talk about the Rutgers defense because they were on the field a long time. They did an outstanding job. They came up with several big plays, especially down on the goal line, that tough hit near the goal line, which stopped the BC apparent touchdown. And you have to look at that and say maybe the defense is hurting Halloran and the BC Eagles offense.
Bruce and I were examining the stats, and we'll show them to you now when you can make your own judgment as to anything that sticks out in your mind. It's apparently the time of possession is an overwhelming thing in the favor of Boston College. Nearly 18 minutes of possession time, yet they've only got 13 points on the board. The turnovers, I don't believe those turnovers are correct. I think BC has turned it over once, and Rutgers has turned it over four times.
And that's a big difference in the first half. Also, Halloran, who had been throwing the ball so well, just 6 for 15 in that first half, 63 yards. Rutgers, as you see, unable to run the football in the first half. Albert Smith, only 10 yards and 5 carries, and Matt Prescott, 4 carries, 7 yards.
So now we will take a look at the first half drives, and Boston College had great opportunities, starting the ball at the Rutgers 50, at the 41, at the 45, at the 42. That's all plus territory, and the worst setup that they had was their own 20-yard line, and that was on their first drive.
And what really hurt Rutgers was field position. Look at this, 14, 15, 20, back inside the 20, back to the 20, Hey, they got it out as far as the 26 to start. You can't do much, Sam, in a situation where you have the ball on your own end and you're trying to come out of there and your offense is having a little bit of trouble anyway. Rutgers will get the football first here in the second half. It might be a different story. But if I'm Coach Dick Anderson, I have to feel great about going in there down 13-3 because the defense just did a fine, fine job.
Sean Halloran getting some extra work along the sideline as you look at some other scores going on today. Number 2-ranked Oklahoma, having just played their first game of the season last week, having some trouble at Kansas State, winning only 7-0. Indiana looking to go 4-0, and the Hoosiers beating Northwestern 17-0. That's a second quarter score. And for those in the Pittsburgh area, the Panthers off to a good start against South Carolina, leading there by a count of 21-7. Coach Fazio and his club desperately need a victory here to get the Wolves off their back. West Virginia having problems with our tribal Virginia Tech. That game is at Mountaineer Field in Morgantown this afternoon. West Virginia having to settle for a 10-10 tie last week. And Georgia Tech beating up on North Carolina. That's also a second quarter score. So you're pretty much up to date. It's 13-3 here with Boston College leading Rutgers, and BC will receive to start the third quarter of play. And so they will have that ball yet again. And Lord knows they've had it enough times, and they've only punched it into the end zone once today.
Well, Bicknell said before the game, we've got to push the ball into the end zone when the opportunity presents itself. BC had a lot of opportunities in that first half, but they come away with only 13 points. Will it hurt them? Will it be a factor? Only time will tell.
Mike Copeland, number 15, is the man who does the kicking off for Rutgers, not Angstead. And here's Copeland's kick. It's high and it is deep. It drives Tyrone Taylor back into the end zone, 2 yards deep. He's coming out to the 15, the 20. He's got an avenue, 30, to the 35, and one saving tackle made by Rutgers' Steve Twomley, number 21, the cornerback, with perhaps a saving tackle. And Boston College again with excellent field position. Let's see how they come out now with Halloran at quarterback and the rest of their offensive set.
Well, they created that opportunity by just a fine return. Here's Halloran's stats on the day. One interception, only 63 yards in the air after a couple of scintillating performances.
They will not have Troy Stratford. He played the first quarter. They go with two tight ends, Casparello and Gieselman, and Williams a tailback. Here's a handoff to Bell for 8 yards. The big fullback, number 24, busting across the 40 to the 43-yard line. And Ken Bell rushes for 8 yards on the first play from scrimmage here in the third quarter.
Bell had 28 yards in the first half. Big hole. Good block. Darren Swamley, the center. And Bell does the rest on his own.
Second down at 2 now. Boston College leading Rutgers 13-3. It's been an up-and-down season for BC. They lost the opener, won the second week, lost the third week, won the fourth against Pitt, lost last week at Miami, trying to win here in the sixth week. Halloran delivers the ball. It's caught at the 40. Williams puts a move on the defender who makes a great open-field tackle. Jim Pacal, number 97, the stand-up defensive end. Number 97, as I mentioned, but not before BC got the first down.
The words I would use to describe that last play, poise and maturity. Halloran might not have been able to do this the first game of the season, but look here. He doesn't find the receiver. He hangs in there. The pressure's coming. He finds the open receiver, and they pick up the first down.
Number 90, John Bronner, out of Trenton, New Jersey, is the upback and the lead block. Look at Williams. Fumbles the ball, and Rutgers has it at the 38-yard line. After a big game, the sophomore tailback coughed it up, and Rutgers has the turnover. The second time BC has coughed the ball up today, and Rutgers now with their best field position. Daryl Brittingham, I think, has the football.
Well, Rutgers gets a break that they really needed, and they'll get good field position out of it. Let's see who strips that football out of there. Tyrone Stowe, 41, was the first man to make contact. Somebody else was underneath there. I think it was number 21, Steve Twomley. Rutgers has the ball on their own 40.
So here comes Joe Gagliardi and company from the I formation. He's got Prescott as the deep back in the eye. Rutgers' best field position of the day. It's play action. Gagliardi's going to keep it. Ooh, bad decision. He gained about 3 yards, but he paid a very stiff price for it. Gorecki was there, and so was Mike Degnan, number 98. And he leveled the quarterback, Joe Gagliardi, after a gain of 3.
It may have been a good decision. It may have been a nice play, but you're right. He did pay the price.
Second down, 7, Rutgers. Gagliardi's stats, not bad. Youngster making his first college start in his senior year. He's been looking up at Eric Hochberg now for the last few years, and finally, Dick Anderson said, go ahead, young man, you've been deserving of a start. We're going to give it to you today. And the give is to the big fullback, Curtis Stevens, for some tough yards across the 45. He'll be 2 or 3 yards shy of the first down. He is stacked up by the middle of the Boston College defense, including Big Mike Ruth, number 68, the 268-pound senior out of Norristown, Pennsylvania. Third down.
Excuse me, in approaching this game, Gagliardi said, I know I'm not going to fail. I'm more mature now. I sat out a lot of time over the past couple of years after the transfer from Tulane, and I'm ready to start.
Third quarters have not been particularly kind to Rutgers. They've scored only 7 points in third quarters of their previous games this season. Gagliardi throwing out here, and it's caught at the 47-yard line by the tight end, Bruce Campbell. And that will be a Scarlet Knights first down as they move into Boston College territory for one of the rare times today.
Just nice execution in this play, though. Although Campbell does slip and go down, he concentrates on the football and makes the catch. Campbell had that big touchdown catch against Florida that brought Rutgers a 28-28 tie.
8 yards on the completed pass. Now Campbell goes strong side to the right from the I formation. Gagliardi pitches to Prescott, trying to get outside and can't do it. Boston College strung it out very nicely. Ted Gaffney, number 57, the linebacker, and Bill Romanowski, number 53, who does some Roman, doesn't he? He is a leading tackler, and they both got out there and stopped the ball carrier after a gain of about a yard.
Boston College has played the run well all afternoon. Good pursuit. They string the play to the outside, and Prescott finally runs out of real estate.
11.5 minutes to go in the third quarter. That's big, Mr. Romanowski. It is second down and a long 8 now for Rutgers. Gagliardi directly back to pass over the middle. Guns one in for the first down. And again, he got it to his tight end, number 88, Scott Allen, senior out of Bridgetown, New Jersey. And so the Scarlet Knights are on the move at the 35-yard line. That was a 9-yard pass, and that's exactly what they needed for the first down. And they move the sticks again, so here they come, Bruce.
Scott Allen says, I feel the urgency to catch the ball anytime it's close. On that last play, he showed you his heart. He reached up, caught the ball, and Rutgers is on the move.
Prescott is the deep back. Play action for Gagliardi. Rifles one to the 27-yard line. Caught by Roy Hoover in front of the defensive back, Neil Icon. And so it goes as a gain of about 6 yards, or 7, depending on where they spot it. Now you can make it 8 yards. He's in the 27-yard line.
Coming at you this time as Rutgers continues to move the ball. Short passes. Hoover on a nice down and out. And the ball was thrown right on the money.
Second down and 2 for Rutgers. They are threatening to get themselves right back in this football game. The up back, Stevens. And very close to another Rutgers first down. Stacked up at the 25-yard line. He is stopped by the middle of the BC defensive line. Route 68, 95, Gorecki, and they move the sticks again. And Jack Bicknell has to be concerned.
This is by far the most impressive drive of the day for Rutgers. Gagliardi now starting to mix things up, go to the air, keep it on the ground. And Rutgers, with good field position, let's see if they can stick it in this time.
They started this drive at their own 40-yard line following the fumble by Williams after he had picked up the first down. They are surely within field goal range for Angstead. Gorecki wants more. Quick out pattern to Allen. Breaks the tackle of the 15 to the 10. Fumbles the ball! And Boston College has it at the goal line. Neil Icon got over to recover the ball. There was nobody but Icon around it. And Dick Anderson has to be disappointed with that particular situation. What a dramatic turn of events as Boston College gets it back at the 1-yard line. It's BC 13, Rutgers 3. We'll be right back.
Make every meal a natural success. Begin with Rutgers gourmet pasta made with durum, semolina, wheat flour, and whole eggs, then frozen for freshness. Rutgers tortellini cheese or meat filling is deliciously different. Homemade pasta's never been so easy. Then include the tempting taste of Lamogna ricotta cheese. For over 50 years, Lamogna cheese has been bringing out the best in pastas. Made with pure milk and hot pack for freshness, Lamogna ricotta cheese refreshes salads and enhances desserts. It's a ricotta for all reasons.
Of Daly's cocktail mixes at your favorite store.
Turnover number 5 of the afternoon for the Scarlet Knights of Rutgers. After a fine drive, the pass completed to Scott Allen. Allen running to daylight at the 10-yard line, coughs it up, BC's Neil Iton picks it up at the 1-yard line. That's where the Eagles will start first and 10.
Everybody lined up in the end zone. That ball is just a yard across the goal line. Allen turns and gives it to his fullback Bell for a couple of very tough yards. Kenny fighting to the 3, maybe the 4-yard line, and Rutgers stuffs him right there. It'll be second down at about 8 now for Boston College, trying to wedge their way out from the shadow of their own goalpost. The clock continues to run, under 9.5 minutes to go, third quarter, and Boston College clinging to a 13-3 lead, and I don't think that's an exaggeration, do you?
No, I don't.
They've been hanging on here. They have not been able to deliver the knockout punch, is what I'm trying to say.
Oh, what a great play by Lou Morrow.
Tracy Giles, the ball carrier, and he loses a yard as Morrow, the strong safety, comes in to shut down the run.
Lou Morrow, number 14, comes up and takes down the ball carrier, Tracy Giles, and boom, makes the play. And DC here, unless they're careful, will be looking at a fourth down where they have to punt from the very edge of the back of the end zone. You need a couple of yards here, and you'd like to move the football at least up to the 5.
Gasparello replaces Scott Gieselman at tight end. It's third down and 9, BC. I formation, Bell again, wedging out to the 4, and that's about it. They will not have much room now with which to operate, and their punter, Steve Peach, will have to kick from the back of the end zone.
BC playing it safe, keeping the ball on the ground. A little bit conservative, but they have the lead. Now they'll punt from deep, and let's see if Rutgers tries to go get the punter.
Apparently, Bicknell was not listening to me during that timeout. I said on first down he ought to throw the fly pattern to Kelvin Martin. I guess that's why he's coaching, huh? Single safety. It is Will Dunster standing at the 45 of Boston College. Peach, no rush, gets off a good high spiral. Short, but good hang time. Dunster's going to run it back at the 45. Trying to get outside the containment. And he's brought down at the 46-yard line. Boston College had to protect first, then come downfield and cover the punt. So Dunster had the opportunity to run it back. He lost a yard on the return after a fine 41-yard punt by Peach under pressure. There's a timeout on the field. 7:58 to go in the third quarter. BC leads it by 10, and we'll be back after this.
Time to sit back and relax to some entertaining late-night television. You can always see what boring local news has to offer.
No!
Okay, how about another documentary on thermonuclear toxic waste?
Back chin up, no more!
Maybe stay up with that start-to-finish bike marathon to Albuquerque.
No!
For the frustrated viewer, there's only one solution. The Untouchables, and you can see it every night at 11 p.m. on Madison Square Garden Network.
That's outrageous.
Of course it is. 7 times a week you'll get to see what made Elliot Ness America's greatest crime fighter.
I know I am.
You gotta love a man with confidence, and you gotta love a show filled with nonstop action.
Ah, right!
So the next time you're tempted to watch boring late-night TV, remember The Untouchables every night at 11 p.m. on Madison Square Garden Network.
That's right.
See all of Dennis Galloway and Tom Hewitt's relatives have made the game today safely. Good. Glad to have them in the stand. From the 46-yard line of BC, Rutgers has the ball. Again, excellent field position. Second back through is Prescott, leaps over a tackler, and is finally contained and dropped to the 45-yard line. Tackle made there by Romanowski again. You know, Bruce, if Rutgers fans want to have reason or cause to be optimistic about this game, let us caution that Boston College's defense has given up 69 points in 5 fourth quarters. You don't have to be a mathematician to figure out that BC wilts late in the ballgame. And Rutgers, if they can hang in there, can be very much alive come the fourth quarter. They're down by only 10 at the moment. It is second down and 9. Gagliardi sprints to his left, delivers a pass, caught at the 40-yard line. It'll be a gain of 5. Roy Hoover, who went in motion, made the catch in front of the linebacker on that side. Ted Gaffney, it's a gain of 5. It'll be third down and 3 now for Rutgers to keep the ball at the Boston College 40-yard line.
Gagliardi is throwing the ball better, at throwing the ball harder in the second half. Hoover running a simple out pattern, grabbing it. Here's another look at it. Gagliardi right on the money with this one. Rutgers left with a 3rd and 4.
Gagliardi back to throw it again. Has two men over the middle, and this one is incomplete. They converge on him this time. Two men were defending against the intended receiver, Hoover, and the man who got his hands on it was number 46, Bill Thompson, who's a stand-up defensive end, and that time dropped back in pass coverage. And number 46 deflected the ball away from the intended receiver, so Rutgers will have to kick.
You know, Bill Thompson's mother is the New Jersey federal court judge. You better be very nice to him.
Well, he made a nice play there. O'Connell back in the kick formation, and he will be punting to Kelvin Martin, who's in the neighborhood of the 10-yard line. Anything over his head, Kelvin assuredly will let go. Good snap. O'Connell looking for something high to drop it at about the 10. Martin calls for the fair catch, goes over his head, and Rutgers is going to kill the ball inside the 10 at about the 8 or 9-yard line. Downfield was Will Dunster. And so BC, again, having had great field position in the first half, started their drive last time from the 1 and now will begin from the 9 after a punt of 31 yards.
But that 31-yard punt is an effective 31. It's better than being 40 for the statistics and in the end zone and out to the 20-yard line. So Boston College working from a hole. Totally different field possession half, isn't it, than the first half?
Yep, it indeed is. Tracy Giles comes out as the tailback. Steve Williams sitting down. Of course, Williams turned that ball over deep in Rutgers territory to stymie a drive. They've got two tight ends, Murphy and Gieselman, and it looks like Jack McNell will want to wedge it out. And here's a give to Giles for a couple of yards to the 12-yard line. Running off his own right tackle, Getzendanner made the stop. That offensive line again has Sean Regent, 54, at left tackle. Jim Ostrowski, 73, at the left guard. Darren Twombly is playing center, replacing Gowetsky. Trapillo is the right guard, and the right tackle is David Waddell. And they are big, as Bruce has told you repeatedly today. Halloran going to throw on second down. Throws the home run ball. He's got Martin, and it's intercepted at the 45. Twombly to the 40, 35 and the 40. He's got blockers. And he's run out of bounds at the 20-yard line. Steve Twombly, who closed quickly on the ball, as Martin appeared to have 5 yards on the defender, and Halloran just laid it up, and it was intercepted. 35 yards on the return.
A great play by Steve Twombly. Otto Neidinger, the defensive coordinator, said earlier in the week that Twombly gets a great break on the football. Here was a play where Kelvin Martin had cleanly beat him, but the ball was floated. Halloran allowed Twombly the time to get back, get under the football, and come up with the interception. And what a play it was.
So Rutgers now with the break they needed from the 19-yard line. They send Hoover in motion to give it to Prescott. He runs right through the middle for 4 yards, puts his head down, and reaches the 15-yard line. And we'll find out now what kind of character the Boston College defense has. We know the character of the Rutgers defense. They have kept the team in the ballgame.
Here's that play again. Look at Twombly get back there. A one-handed circus catch. And now he turns it upfield. Pretty good running back, you might be.
5:15 to go, third quarter. Rutgers with their best scoring opportunity of the game. Gagliardi rolling left. He's got room if he wants to run it. To the 10. To the 8-yard line. Steps out of bounds. It'll be very close to a Rutgers first down. Should be first down and goal to go, the Scarlet Knights. And the crowd has come alive here at the Meadowlands.
Gagliardi scrambling, showing you good mobility. It's an option bootleg play where he can throw or keep the ball. And a la Leon Russell, he tightrope down the left sideline.
So here they come with a first down and goal inside the 8-yard line. Prescott got is the deep back in the eye. Stevens the fullback. Gagliardi delivers the ball. It's incomplete. He tried the play to his tight end, Scott Allen, who worked so beautifully earlier in this quarter, and Allen then fumbled the ball and was recovered at the one-yard line. It was the same play, the tight end with a quick release, but this one was covered.
Well, the Rutgers defense has held periodically today, and now they have given the opportunity to the offense to come up with some points. You can't ask for much more than that.
Two tight ends employed by Rutgers, number 89 Campbell, number 88 Scott Allen. It's been a most interesting football game. Hope you've enjoyed it on the TCS Sports Network. Joe Gagliardi on second and goal. Keeps it, arches it in the end zone. Touchdown, Rutgers to Campbell.
Bruce Campbell was an unknown before the season began. He played in the shadows of Alan Andrews, Rutgers' fine tight end. And this year, he is blossoming. First, it was a touchdown catch against Florida, and now a big one here against Boston College as Rutgers gets back in the football game. Well-lofted throw that time by Gagliardi.
Tom Angstad will attempt to put on the 10th point now for Rutgers, and they are right back in it. The placement of the kick by Angstad is up, and it's perfect. We have 4:55 to go, third quarter. It's now Boston College 13 and Rutgers 10. We'll be right back after this.
Daily's cocktail mixes at your favorite store.
I know. How does the seafood sound?
Sounds good to me. Sounds good to me.
Long John Silver's got batter fried shrimp, breaded shrimp, scallops, clams, even oysters.
Sounds like the taste in a place I want to be. Sounds good. Sounds great. Come on.
Play was pretty enough that we thought you ought to see it again.
One of Rutgers' favorite play, a bootleg option, left side. Quarterback looks to throw to the tight end, and there he is, Bruce Campbell, wide open. Touchdown, Rutgers.
Just over the outstretched hands of the defender there, and so the kick now coming from Mike Copeland. He has the ball on the kicking tee at the 40-yard line. And in the deep receiving spots, number 21, Tyrone Taylor, and number 30, Tracy Giles. And again, I remind you, Tracy Stratford played the first quarter. A hamstring apparently bothered him, and so he went to the dressing room, changed clothes, now in civvies, and unavailable to Boston College the rest of the day. This is Taylor at the 3-yard line. 15 to 20, cuts it straight up the middle, reaches the 28-yard line. Very good return. Boston College has an excellent return game, both on the punts and the kickoffs. Dan Lipset made the stop after a 28-yard return. And the scoring drive culminated by that short touchdown pass to Campbell. There it is. It wasn't very far.
Now that's being efficient. Four plays, 47 seconds.
Well, let's see if Halloran now can answer the call. 13 to 10, Boston College, a game that some people might have thought they should have had this one as a laugher. They had numerous opportunities in the first half. They blew them all except for one. And they now find themselves in a death struggle with Rutgers. Give us to Bell, to the 33-yard line, picking up 4 yards on the carry. Getson Danner, number 95, made the stop. But that Rutgers defense, which has been tough all day, Bruce, now has reason to be even better.
And I think the pressure has now changed a little bit. I think there's pressure on the BC offense now to make something happen. Before, they had a 10-point lead. It wasn't necessary. It wasn't urgent for them to make something happen. Now, it's a 3-point game. I think old momentum is swinging in Rutgers' favor, and BC has to do something on offense.
It is second down and 6. Gieselman goes strong side to the left. Martin is in the slot to the right. And Darren Flutie, who hasn't caught a pass, is the receiver. Bell on a delay. He's got open field at the 40. Spins to the 43 and gets a first down. He's knocked down by Lou Morrow, but Boston College, in a delay, gives it off to Bell, who is now being asked to carry the brunt of the load from the running back position.
Well, Boston College calls that an influence trap play. What they try to do here is first, you see, the guard set up like it's a pass play, and then the delay, the handoff, and the fullback gets the football, and on the draw, runs effectively.
It is not any accident that Rutgers secondary has performed so well. They held John Schaefer of Penn State to 64 yards passing last Saturday in losing by only 7 to the Nittany Lions. Tyrone Taylor, the ball carrier, goes head over heels across the 45 to the 46, depending on where they spot it. Gained of 3. And the stop made by Stowen gets in Danner again. So it'll be second down at 7. And now we have an injured Rutgers player, Matt Backman, who has played very well in this game. In fact, has an interception and is limping off the far side. Rutgers can ill afford to lose anybody, as you know.
And Bachman, who came back after missing almost all of last year with a broken ankle. There's that New Jersey on the helmet we were talking about a little bit earlier. There's no question that
New Jersey school.
Rutgers and New Jersey working together, trying to establish some type of main rapport.
Second and 7, Giles finds it very difficult as he gains maybe a yard. Big play by Tyrone Stowe, but he was ably assisted there by Jim Pacal, number 97, the senior from Maspeth, New York. And so now Halloran's in a very difficult position as he approaches midfield. He's 3rd down and 5. As you see Backman on the sideline being attended to. 3rd down and 5. And into the game now comes Taylor with the play, presumably from Jack McNeil. So Boston College's offense has done nothing since the touchdown pass from Halloran to Martin.
You blitz here, 3rd and 5.
Look at that. Look at the 3rd down conversions. 2 for 11. Taylor doesn't get it again. To the 48-yard line, he will be a yard shy. George Pacal made the stop, and Boston College is going to have to give it up, I believe. They had to get to the 47.5-yard line, and they are not at that point. They're a good yard shy of the first down, and here comes Peach to punt again.
Rutgers played run, and they get correctly.
So Steve Peach, who has punted very well, averaging 41 yards on 5 punts, will try to kick one down there and knock it out somewhere inside the 20. Dunster is back, good high spiral. Dunster, fair catch at the 8-yard line. So an excellent punt by Steve Peach of 40 yards with no return. And Rutgers now trying to fight for the lead. They have an opportunity, but they've got 92 yards to traverse to get into a tie football game as they begin from their own 8-yard line.
Well, the Rutgers offense has looked very cohesive in this third quarter of play. And now, starting from deep in their own end, it will be interesting to see how Gagliardi elects to attack if he goes to the ground game or starts rolling again and looking for his tight end and tries to get the pass game moving.
They spot the ball on the 9, so let's call that the line of scrimmage, and Gagliardi from the I formation. Joe has played very, very well today. Hoover in motion, and the pitch is to Prescott. And he gets outside and run out of bounds as he crosses the 10-yard line to about the 12 or 13. Bill Romanowski from the inside linebacker slot with good lateral movement got over to the sideline with a pickup of about 3 or 4 yards.
Prescott has played a lot today. Albert Smith not in the football game. Curtis Stevens is the fullback. Prescott playing the tailback spot. And as you saw, he has the ability to turn the corner.
Gain of 4, 2nd down and 6 now for Rutgers. Stevens is the up back, and Hoover in motion again. And the give again to Prescott, and he reaches the 15-yard line. He'll be shy of the first down, picking up a couple of yards. Number 68, Mike Ruth, was there.
And Romanowski was there. Romanowski is really physical.
3rd down and 4 for the Rutgers Scarlet Knights, trying to keep their drive alive. Of course, I would suspect Dick Anderson will not get careless here. Young comes out wide to the left, and Gagliardi will sprint to his right. He delivers the ball, and it is incomplete at the 18-yard line. And that time, they sent a man out with him. The linebacker, I think it may have been Romanowski. Or was it a defensive back? It was Carl Crushpain, number 35, the safety, who blitzed, and he blitzed toward the point that Gagliardi was sprinting. And so I think Boston College now getting a bit wiser to the sprint-out passes of Gagliardi. And the punter is O'Connell back at his own goal line.
That was a good defensive series by the Eagles.
Kelvin Martin awaiting this punt at the 50. O'Connell will hit it in the neighborhood of the 5-yard line with 1:02 to go in the third quarter. And a good punt. Drives Martin all the way back to his own 41-yard line. Comes right up the middle. Now tries, fumbles the ball! The scramble is on, and Boston College indicates they have it, but my goodness! Jack McNeil must have held his breath there for a split second. 44 yards on the punt, 11 on the return as Martin coughs up the ball. But BC recovers it at the 43-yard line.
Well, there's no question he's dangerous and he's exciting, but once in a while, he's prone to error when you're running that carelessly with the football. Twombly was right on top of him, but the ball squirted free and right in the direction of another Boston College player. Watch how he loses the ball. Twombly is right there, number 21, but the ball goes underneath him, behind him, and there's Boston College recovery.
Yeah, they can thank Jim Turner, number 40, for that recovery. Special teams player who makes a very big play. Here's a dive off the left side to the 38-yard line, Tracy Giles, who has not found it very easy for him to run the football today. Game 3, second down 7, Boston College now at the Rutgers 39-yard line.
Hey, Sam, did you know that Tracy Giles was a World Junior skeet shooting champion under 18?
No, I didn't know that. Did you stay up all night with an all-nighter here on Boston College? Trivial information.
I can't even pronounce that one.
Bell runs into his own blocker, goes outside to the 35, spins to the 32. A great effort by Kenny Bell, the senior out of Greenwich, Connecticut, as he spun off a tackle and got the first down for Boston College. Great effort.
Boston College has really moved the football better on the ground in the second half than in the air. Another delay trap. And a big block of Ostrowski. Look at Bell sneak to the outside.
At the 31-yard line of Rutgers, here comes Boston College again. They have been threatening, it seems, all day. Yet they lead by only 3. 15 seconds to go here in the third quarter. Martin in motion. And he turns and gives to Bell right up the gut inside the 25 to the 23-yard line. And Kenny Bell having himself quite an afternoon. As he approaches the 100-yard mark, he should be in the 70s, I would guess. We'll get a stat on Kenny Bell for you. But he has carried the front of the load here with Stratford out.
So far this afternoon, Bell, 13 carries, 70 yards. And when you see a hole open up as big as that one, you know the front three are doing the job.
We've played three quarters at the Meadowlands. It's Boston College 13, Rutgers 10. We'll be back after this.
You enjoy the action on the field and the added attraction along the sidelines. Cheerleading's the dream of many girls and guys. Now you can get your young athletes on their way to tryouts with Get Up and Cheer. Get Up and Cheer, a video cassette on the basics of cheerleading with instruction by the nationally recognized Penn State cheerleaders. Everything from warm-up exercises and proper technique to gymnastic tumbling and partner stunts, all demonstrated on this action-packed cassette. To order your VHS or beta copy of Get Up and Cheer, send a check or money order for $34.95 to CBS, Box 11300, 701 Alpha Drive, Pittsburgh, 15238. Or use MasterCard or Visa. Call toll-free, 800-531-5314. Add $2 for shipping and handling. Pennsylvania residents add 6% sales tax. Your little cheerleader will get unlimited enjoyment from Get Up and Cheer. Send your order now. TCS, Box 11300, 701 Alpha Drive, Pittsburgh, 15238. Or call toll-free, 800-531-5314 for MasterCard or Visa. Allow 6 weeks for delivery.
Hi, Jack.
The usual, Pat.
No, not that. Too much tonight.
So you want it light?
Right, but I want to taste the bite.
Sack time.
Sack time?
Try sack on ice, to be precise. Try the taste. What do you think?
Nice drink.
Light?
White.
Bite? Right. Sack time. John, you're on.
Dry sack over ice. When you want it light, but you still want to taste the bite.
The usual, Matt?
No, not that. Too much tonight.
So you want it light?
Right, but I want to taste the bite.
Billy? Bobby? Have you seen the Yellow Pages?
Ask Dad.
Hon, where's the Yellow Pages?
Ask Billy.
I asked Billy.
Ask Bobby.
I asked Bobby.
Ask Gramps.
Over the years, one book has been in more homes helping people throughout New York find more goods and services. the 9X Yellow Pages. It's always there when you need it.
Sam Nover and Bruce Beck, we're back at the Meadowlands. You see the score as we start play here in the fourth quarter. It is second down and three, Boston College. They lead by three, and they have the ball at the Rutgers 24-yard line. They have been knocking on the door of Rutgers all day long and have only gotten in once. Bell gets the first down. He has been the most effective ball carrier in the game as Kenny runs it inside the 20 to the 17-yard line, picking up 6 yards. Stopped there by Roy Oak, number 44, and Tyrone Stowe, who's got a slew of tackles, number 41. But not before Boston College gets the first down. They take it back now and spot it right on the 18.
Right guard Steve Trapillo did a super job that time blocking. You know, the BC Eagles blockers really pass block for a living, but right now they've got to do it on the ground.
This is historically this year not been a good quarter for Boston College. They've been outscored, as I mentioned, by an astronomical amount, 69-21. Big hole for Bell to the 10-yard line. Inside the 10 to maybe the 9. Lou Morrow with a saving tackle. But they're certainly starting this fourth quarter out with a blaze of glory. Bell very close to another BC first down. This is almost a throwaway play. It'll be second down and one now, and Bell has 85 yards and 15 carries. What a day.
Well, you can talk all you want about cliches. You can talk about big plays, this and that, but what it really boils down to football is execution, hard hitting, good blocking and tackling. And in this particular series, that offensive line is just winning the game in the trenches.
Marco Wetzke now in at center. I said he suffered a broken nose last week. Here's a dive play over the top and very close to a first down is Mahalik. Big John the senior, number 34 out of Elyria, Ohio, trying to get BC the first down and goal to go, and I believe he did.
Now this is where the going gets tough. In the first half, Rutgers was able to hold BC out of the end zone, force them to kick a field goal. Now Boston College has four downs to push the football 7 yards, but Rutgers has been tough down here all season long.
And they make wholesale offensive changes here. Bell is in. Giaquinto is in. Taylor is in. Giaquinto comes wide to the left. Kelvin Martin to the right. First and goal. Now Martin in motion. And the pitch is to the short side. Taylor to the 3-yard line. Quick pitch to Tyrone Taylor. And Tyrone Stowe made the stop at the 3.
He saved the touchdown, too.
Kenny Bell led the interference as they went to the short side of the field and picked up a quick 4 yards.
Watch Tyrone Stowe play here. Otherwise, you're talking about 6 points. He's the only man that can stop Taylor. And he gets them.
Two tight ends on second and goal. Three tight ends. Gieselman, 83. Gasparello, 85. Murphy, 89. What a monstrous offensive line that is. Taylor is the tailback. Halloran turns and gives it to him. And a whistle, and we may have delay of game against Boston College.
That is a costly penalty.
Oh, my goodness.
It is not the time you want to make a mistake. When you're down that goal line, you've got to watch that 25-second clock.
What a break for Rutgers. Second down and 8 now.
Delay of game. Offense. Second down.
Well, that may change their plan somewhat. Martin comes back in the game. Giles, Mahalik, Taylor comes out. Murphy comes out. And so does Kenny Bell. I can't understand why Bell isn't in there. I don't care whether he plans on throwing it or not. Bell is the man who got him here. He has virtually carried this drive down the field.
Two tight ends also now for BC.
Giles is a deep back in the eye. He gets the ball. And he is hit at the 5 and snowed under. Good play by Roy Oak, the senior out of Piscataway, New Jersey, number 44, stops him at the 5. So it's third down and goal to go, and here comes BC again with another golden opportunity.
This is Oak and Stowe, 44 and 41. Top two tacklers last year, and Oak made the big hit, Stowe finished them off.
Giles, 11 carries, 27 yards. This Rutgers defense has been, in a word, spectacular. Third and 5. Fumble! 15-yard line. Taylor is brought down. Jepson Danner brought him down, but somebody screwed up that play from its inception. It appeared to me as if that quarterback Halloran wanted to run the option, and somebody was in his face immediately.
And that somebody was Alec Hoke, number 69. Watch Hoke from the blind side come up, knock that ball away, and then Steve Plumlee misses, but Getson Danner gets there now. A field goal attempt of 31 yards.
Rooney is 2 for 2 today. The placement by Flutie, the kick is up, and it is no good. He misses it to the left. What a defensive stand by the Scarlet Knights. And if that doesn't get their offense pumped up, nothing will. As you look at an unhappy and maybe confused Jack Bicknell, there's a timeout with a score of Boston College 13, Rutgers 10. We'll be back after this.
Flemington, New Jersey is car and truck country. It has the largest selection and the best prices anywhere because Flemington Car and Truck Country is made up of 5 dealerships that sell in volume and save you money. They are Ditchman, Flemington, Ford, Lincoln, Mercury, Flemington, Dodge, Chrysler, Plymouth, and Dodge Truck, Flemington, Buick, GMC, and Isuzu Trucks, Flemington, Nissan, Datsun, and Flemington, BMW. All offer a $500 reward to you if they can't beat the competition's price. Visit Flemington Car and Truck Country, all together on Route 202 and 31 in Flemington.
Are you knocking yourself out looking for advertising that works?
Yeah.
You've tried almost everything, right? Newspapers, radio, even direct mail, and you're still not getting results, right?
Right.
Well, cable advertising is the answer. Cable reaches the market and customers your business needs. The channel selection offers you, the advertiser, the media variety to achieve those elusive results. Call TKR Advertising today at 356-1220. We've got the solution.
This has been a heartbreaking season for Rutgers thus far. They, of course, tied Florida, which was their moment of glory, then lost by 4 to Army, lost to Penn State by 7. They trail here by 3 as Gagliardi's going to run it, 25. And he's knocked out of the 26 to 27-yard line. The hit made by Garrett McPherson. But Gagliardi, who was a great threat to run the ball and throw it, running that option, picks up 7 yards.
I think your point is well taken that Rutgers has proven they can play with anybody in the country. Now they want to show that they can win. That's really what the bottom line is. Coach Dick Anderson says a W will do wonders for the football team.
Well, they're coming off a 7-3 year and disappointed, might I add, that they didn't get a bowl bid last year. It's second down and 3 now for Gagliardi and the Rutgers Scarlet Knights, looking to get at least a tie and hopefully for them to go ahead touchdown. Prescott running across people over the 31 to the 32-yard line. John Bosa, the senior defensive tackle, made the stop. But Matt Prescott picked up the first down. He's seen a lot of action today. And here comes Rutgers from their own 33-yard line.
Total yardage in this game, just about even. Rutgers, 233, 169 in the air, 64 on the ground. Boston College, 260, with only 68 in the air, 172 on the ground.
Prescott, 25 yards and 10 carries. Gagliardi has been the man who's put the offense on the board. Here's a play-action pass. He wants all of it. Fires it downfield. He's got a receiver, and it's just out of his outstretched hand. Intended for number 36, Roy Hoover, the sophomore from Audubon Park, 5'10", 160 pounds. And back to cover was Neil Iton, and there is an injured Boston College player down. Get the glasses on him. He's being attended to right on the 30-yard line. Gagliardi had some time to throw the football. Some good blocking up front.
There's a good block by Glenn Fine. Also some help from Clement Yudovich. And when you get blocking like that and you have time, you can do things. You know, his roommate is Yudovich and also Jim Keating, two offensive linemen. He's smart enough to know that you ought to live with linemen.
So while they attend to the injured Eagle on the field, we'll take a timeout. The score is still Boston College 13 and Rutgers 10. And we'll return to the Meadowlands after this.
Madison Square Garden Network presents the biggest blockbuster of the year, the New York Rangers. Join the local heroes as they set off on a six-month quest in search of Patrick Division glory. Follow the squad as they attack, hustle, and defend their way against enemy lines. They start their journey Thursday, October 10th at 7:30 on the MSG Network, facing the Washington Capitals in the season opener. Your teams play here on Madison Square Garden Network.
I'm very selective in what I do. I'm very selective with my women, and I'm very selective with my television set. My television set is huge.
So are my women. Madison Square Garden Network is the network that I watch because the best are on it. And the best part about it is that almost every time I turn Madison Square Garden Network on, I'm on. And it just thrills me to death.
You too will thrill to Roddy, his friends, and his enemies with three action-packed one-hour wrestling spectaculars each week on MSG Network.
The injured Eagle was Bill Thompson, the defensive right end, number 46, has played a great game, the native of Trenton, New Jersey, being helped to the sideline. It is now second down and 10 after Gagliardi went for all of it, and he gives off in the middle of Prescott, breaks the tackle, and spins his way to the 37-yard line. He is knocked down there by Carl Pellegata, the free safety, number 49. It'll be third down, and I would guess about five now, for Rutgers to keep the football. Under 10 and a half minutes to play in the game, and Boston College leading here by a score of 13-10.
Pretty good run here by Prescott. Tony Rigoli out in front of him. And he spins and spins a la Tony Dorsett. Turn and turn, and you can take that hit and keep moving.
Hoover wide to the left. Gagliardi back to pass. Over the middle, got a man coming free. It's Hoover. He's got the first down at the 48-yard line of Rutgers. And the Scarlet Knights keep their drive alive. Bill Romanowski, number 53, made the tackle. But at the 49-yard line, it will be first down Rutgers.
All right, we're going to watch Romanowski in this play. He sees the play turn upfield. Watch him turn. He goes after Hoover. He knows the play's behind him, and he goes after him and makes the tackle. That's great determination on the part of Romanowski.
11 yards on the play. Gagliardi has accounted for over 200 yards himself. 180 through the air, 26 yards and four carries. He has had himself quite an afternoon in his first college start, replacing the Hochberg. And this one was in and out of the hands of Bruce Campbell.
And that was catchable.
It was right in his hands. Stops the clock with 9:38 to play in the game. And Rutgers trailing here 13-10. Boston College rock back on their heels. And they're just hanging on for dear life now.
Jack Dicknell, in his fifth season, has done marvelous things here at Boston College. His first year, the club really struggled. They were only 5-6, and then 8-3-1, 9-3, and 10-2.
Second and 10, here's Prescott through a gaping hole to the 45-yard line. He'll still be 3 yards shy of a first down. This tackle again made by Romanowski, 53. But it'll be third down and 3 now for Rutgers as they move into Boston College territory.
Prescott running really well, 37 yards now, and 12 carries, and beginning to churn it out in this drive. Romanowski, there he is again.
We have played this entire game with the lights on at the Meadowlands, but the sun now is peeking through the clouds. It has been overcast. We started the day actually in a rainstorm, and then when we came to you live, the sun was shining brightly, and now it's gone under a heavy overcast. And the pass intended for Campbell is incomplete. He never got free.
No, he did.
He was being hit at the chucked around there for the, in the five-yard zone, and he never got free of the man who was trailing him, Gorecki.
Absolutely. Chuck Gorecki was all over Campbell. And in that instant, Joe Gagliardi had to throw to a spot because there was some pressure. And unfortunately, Campbell could never release, and he's down on the field. Last week, he suffered a concussion against Penn State. He looks to be okay, though. Okay, now let's watch it. Top of your screen, now coming down. Gorecki is all over that man, and Gagliardi, with some pressure, has to throw it to a spot, and Campbell can't break away. Gorecki with fine defensive play.
So on fourth down, and trotting off under his own power is tight end Bruce Campbell. On fourth down, Kelvin Martin in single safety at his 10-yard line, and this field is now bathed in sunshine. It's absolutely beautiful. Temperature in the high 60s here in New Jersey, and O'Connell will hit the ball at about his own 45.
Kelvin Martin always dangerous back there.
Some pressure. O'Connell with a good high punt. It'll sail into the end zone for the touchback and come out to the 20. And so Sean Halloran and the offensive unit, they moved the ball early, put 13 points on the board, haven't done much since then. 44 yards on the punt. There's a timeout on the field. 8:51 to go in the game. BC clinging to a three-point lead. And we'll be right back after this.
Make every meal a natural success. Begin with Rocca's Gourmet Pasta, made with durum, semolina, wheat flour, and whole eggs, and frozen for freshness. Rocca's tortellini with cheese or meat filling is deliciously different. Homemade pasta's never been so easy. Add the goodness and quality of Odenwald fruits and the Lico vegetables. Odenwald is an orchard of fine fruits hand-picked and perfectly preserved in their naturally light juices. The Lika vegetables are harvested at the peak of flavor and quick-packed to capture that farm freshness.
Cocktail mixes at your favorite store.
Join us for our next telecast of Eastern College football next Saturday, October 12th, 12 noon. The Scarlet Knights of Rutgers and the Temple Owls at the Vet in Philadelphia on the TCS Sports Network. I hope you'll join Bruce and me for our coverage. Our crew from Altoona won't be there, Ted Beam, Charlie Fisher, and we've appreciated their support. First down and 10 to go, Boston College spinning his bell. He breaks a tackle to the 25 and gets the first down to the 31-yard line. I am impressed with Kenny Bell, the senior out of Greenwich, Connecticut, now rapidly approaching 100 yards. He's at 96 after that 11-yard carry and has had an outstanding day.
And keep in mind that Boston College's fullback is considered their blocking back. That's pretty good yardage.
Bell now comes out of the lineup.
You know, what happened today is when Stratford got hurt and Bell was the fullback and Stratford the tailback, they decided to give Bell the work. He responded.
From the I formation, first down and 10 to go, BC at its own 31-yard line. Halloran has to call timeout. Something obviously startled him and confused him. Halloran, 7 out of 17, throwing the ball for 68 yards. We'll be right back after this break. BC still leads it by 3.
Out here, it's me alone against the course. But in the financial world, you need all the help you can get. You need the Payne Webber army behind you.
Even golf legends can use some financial backup. Payne Webber is ready to roll, putting all its resources at your command. We believe the quality of life just might depend on the quality of your financial services.
Thank you, Payne Webber. Now that's the kind of army you want behind you.
The Meadowlands offers the special start-to-finish excitement of nighttime thoroughbred racing. Driving power and head-to-head competition as jockey and horses one thunder to the finish line. All the action and suspense of thoroughbred racing. It happens again and again, night after night, at the Meadowlands.
First down at 10 to go, Boston College. Halloran now got his signal straight with Coach Jack McNeil. Mahalik is the upback. And they send the man in motion. Busted play. And Halloran got 4 yards out of it. I'll tell you what happened. The tailback, Tracy Giles, started forward and then was committed to having to move into motion. He moved a couple of steps and stopped. He was to be the ball carrier, and Halloran had to keep it on a busted play.
Boston College, as we mentioned, has run the ball a lot today. 47 running plays. Rutgers with just 28 running plays.
Tyrone Taylor now into tailback. Boy, McNeil changes his tailbacks on every play. Second down and 6. Halloran was lucky to get 4 yards out of that busted effort. And now Sean on a naked reversal, bootleg keeper. Throws it downfield. He's got a man. It's completed the Rutgers 47-yard line. Kelvin Martin out of bounds just in front of the Rutgers bench, but that will be a Boston College first down. And Halloran, I believe, Bruce, needed that for his own confidence. He has not thrown the ball well today at all.
That play was set up very well. Watch Halloran make the pitch, run right, it is naked, no one's in front of him, and then he just calmly pulls up and finds Kelvin Martin, who is sure to keep at least one leg inbound. Kelvin Martin runs a hard pattern, breaks to the outside, and keeps an eye on that sideline and says, make sure that one puts in, and he gets it in, gets to it.
Taylor, the deep back in the eye, Boston College trying to move the ball now and keep the clock running. Halloran, short drop, delivers an out pattern to Martin. Trying to spin away, but a good tackle in the open field at the 40-yard line. The play was made by Steve Twombly, the junior from Princeton Junction, New Jersey. 5'11", 180 pounds, has made a big play on interception already in this game.
I think that was an audible because Halloran looked and yelled to Kelvin Martin right before he threw the ball. And Martin had single coverage. He's dangerous to have single coverage with his great speed. If he would have broken that tackle, he could have been gone.
It is second down and 2.5 now for BC. Darren Flutie is split wide to the right. Into the slot is Kelvin Martin. They got one setback there, and it's Kenny Bell, and he gets the pitch, and he gets the first down, and he gets out of bounds after gaining about 4 or 5 yards. Shoved out by Jay Getzendanner. That'll stop the clock with 6:51 to play in the game, but he has done it again. Bell, I think, is very close to 100 now as he gets the first down.
Just under 100 yards on the afternoon. Boston College trying to have a time-consuming drive. It would be the perfect thing to do now. Leading by 3, 8:51 on the clock. They want to advance the football, but they'd love to eat the clock, and keeping the ball on the ground does that for you.
From the 36-yard line of the Rutgers Scarlet Knights, Martin is out in single coverage. Now, Twombly's the only man out there. And then if you're looking for that setup, Halloran couldn't ask for a better one. Here's Giles on the pitch. 35, and Phipson falls at the 33-yard line. And helping him go down was Alec Hope, number 69, the junior from Princeton, after a gain of about 3 yards on the carry. Giles has had problems keeping his footing on this wet surface today. And has not been a very effective runner at all, but he is only a freshman out of Southboro and a lot of future at BC. Flutie comes wide to the left this time, and Martin is slotted. In the I formation, second down 7, Boston College, they lead by 3. And the blitz is on. Halloran throws it downfield, it's incomplete. He threw a post pattern to Flutie.
And Flutie broke to the sideline.
Exactly what happened. A flag is down at the 10-yard line, but that's exactly what happened, Bruce. We may have a push-off here. And we'll just have to wait and see what the official rules.
Well, there was nobody near that toss.
Well, it certainly was uncatchable where it was delivered. A push-off against Rutgers. Well, maybe they say he pushed him away from the post.
Let's see. Howard's straight drop back. Can't see anything yet. Oh, there's Martin. He's got his hands. Oh, it already happened, Martin's saying. I was pushed away.
Okay. Well, then,
do you want to take his word for it?
Flutie was not the intended receiver.
No.
It looked like it was, but that was not the case. Let us pause 5 seconds for station identification. This is the TCS Sports Television Network. Sam Nover and Bruce Beck at the Meadowlands. First down, Boston College inside the 20. The pitch. Getting outside with the ball and sporting free into the end zone is a touchdown, Tyrone Taylor. Good block by Kenny Bell, who's done everything today. And Taylor dashes 18 yards into the end zone, and Boston College has scored.
Well, it's great to be back, Tyrone Taylor says, recovering from his toe injury. First week of the season back. And he does this really all on his own. First, he breaks to the outside. There's the block you were talking about with Bell. Now here, he cuts against the grain, gets away from Oak, and a couple of Rutgers players, maybe didn't see him, cut across, and he breaks in for a touchdown.
Here's the
slippery, elusive.
It was a great play. Here's the extra point attempt by David Rooney. Out of Flutie's hold, it's up, and it is perfect. Let us just correct before we go away again. We gave you the indication the interference call was against Flutie. It was against Kelvin Martin on the pass play earlier, the pushing call, which set up that touchdown run by Taylor. Now, we've got a timeout on the field. Boston College is forged in front by 10 again. It's 20-10. We'll be back after this.
In an hour or two, these streets will be teeming with people, all going after the same thing. The American dream of success. But while there are millions of men and women chasing the American dream, there's only so much of it to go around, which is why you should subscribe to the Wall Street Journal. Each business day, the Journal gives you a real competitive advantage with comprehensive news coverage, analysis, ideas you can put to excellent use in your work, and business information you won't find anywhere else. Of course, you don't have to subscribe to the Journal. In a very short time, these streets will be filled with people who do.
Call 800 527-2600 for this new journal offer. 13 weeks for just $28 with a money-back guarantee. 13 weeks, $28. Phone 800-527-2600 now for the Wall Street Journal.
At this time, TCS would like to thank the following individuals for their assistance in the production of today's telecast. From BC, Athletic Director William Flynn, the head coach Jack Bicknell, Sports Information Director Reed Oslin, and from Rutgers University, Athletic Director Fred Grunninger, the head coach Dick Anderson, and the Sports Information Director Bob Smith, and Tom Peters of that staff. They've all been of great help to both Bruce and me in preparing for this game today, and we appreciate it very much. Albert Smith and Matt Prescott in the deep receiving spots, and here is Rooney's kick. It bounces and is fielded by Smith at the 3. Comes back to the 20-yard line and dives across the 20 to the 22 or 23-yard line. And that's where Rutgers will put it in play, a 20-yard return, as Boston College finally got it back in the end zone. Nice drive at that.
It was. It was an interesting blend of passing and running, and then the fine touchdown run by Tyrone Taylor to Pedrick.
Also an 18-yard pass to Kelvin Martin in that drive helped to keep it alive.
And that's pretty efficient, 80 yards in 252.
5:54 to go. Gagliardi now is going to have to use the airwaves. And he throws it right over the middle, in and out of the hands of Matt Prescott. And it stops the clock with 5:50 to play. And Rutgers needing a touchdown conversion and field goal to tie, not to mention two touchdowns to win this game.
It's been a crazy afternoon out here. First it rained early today, absolutely a downpour. Then it got sunny for a while, then it clouded up again. It's been interesting for most of us, but it's been a video shader's nightmare.
From the 22-yard line, you are right. Second down and 10 now for the Scarlet Knights. And Gagliardi throwing on virtually every down. Fires this one, it's caught over the middle. Allen breaks the tackle and gets the first down very near the 40-yard line. Bill Romanowski made the tackle secure as Allen broke a tackle at the 33 and picked up an additional 4 or 5 yards. That play covering 16, and what an outstanding player Scott Allen is. A rather undersized tight end at only 6'2", 215, or 220. I guess he could put some weight on, but he's got a great pair of hands. Play action, Gagliardi throwing on every down, and he avoids the rush. To the 45 and out of bounds, chased out on the far side of the field. Stopping the clock with 5.5 minutes to play. Chuck Gorecki ran him out.
He turned a potentially dangerous play into a big game. There's Tyrone Stowe. He's been on the field a long time today, and he has played an outstanding football game. And as far as Rutgers fans are concerned, he'll be back next year. He's just a junior.
From the 45-yard line, Gagliardi scrambling for 7 yards. It's second down and 3. He does not want to have to use that kind of precious time to run around with the ball. The blitz, they've got him, and he delivers the ball to nobody in particular. They do not call it intentional grounding, although I don't see a receiver in the vicinity. Rick Nickerson, the senior from Wellesley, Massachusetts, had the pressure on.
He's lucky to get out of this one clean. Here's the pressure. First Nickerson. Couple more coming at him. Nobody is in the area where he throws the football. He got away with one that time.
Excuse my stupidity, but apparently they don't have an in-the-grasp rule in college football.
Not yet.
Not yet. From the 45-yard line. It is now third down and 7 for Gagliardi. 15-31, 196 yards for Joe. One touchdown, 2 intercepts. And play action rolling to his right. He's got company going out there, and they've got him. A good play by the linebacker, Ted Gaffney, who was not fooled. And he throws Gagliardi for a loss back at the 43-yard line.
Had good coverage in the secondary. Fresh paint, Pellegata, both back there. And Gagliardi had nowhere to go here. He's looking for his big tight end. Coverage is out there, and he's got to keep the football. And this time he can't elude the grasp of Teddy Gaffney.
So it comes down to this now for Rutgers, fourth down and 7, and they are not going to punt the football. Lindstrom in at linebacker, Nickerson comes out, fourth down and 7. Receivers are split left and right, and the wing is to the right, Prescott. Gagliardi delivers the ball, caught at the 50, to the 45 by Eric Young, and he picks up that big Rutgers first down at the 44-yard line. An excellent throw and catch, Gagliardi to Eric Young, and Garrett McPherson made the stop.
You can talk all you want about pressure, but Joe Gagliardi in the hot seat, sits there, and calmly fires for the first down. The freshman Eric Young, who has a world of talent, a speedster from New Brunswick, New Jersey.
Back live again. Gagliardi stepping up in the pocket, delivers the ball to Prescott. At the 38, fumbles the ball, and Boston College has it. Prescott fumbled the ball, and Carl Freshpain recovers at the 38-yard line. And Rutgers is arguing that the man's knee had already touched the ground. The official rules the other way, and BC is being given the football. And the Rutgers fans are booing loudly.
I'm not sure about this call. The referee is still talking to his staff. Let's watch it again. Gagliardi back to throw, runs with the football, and finally steps up, hits Prescott, and he's down. He looked like he was down, and then the ball squirted free.
And they've given the ball back to Rutgers and give the officials credit for having changed their decision.
All right, here's another look at it. Is he down with possession? Yes, he is. He's down, and then the ball squirts free. Good call, and an excellent job by the officials to change the call.
So from the 37-yard line, it is now second down and four for Rutgers as they give them the ball back again. Gagliardi running with it for the first down to the 30. And a hook slide at the 27-yard line. He's got the first down. So Gagliardi moving his team downfield with 4:03 to play in the game. And do not count the Scarlet Knights out of this one.
Gagliardi again shows you he can run with the football. I don't know if he's a Yankee or Blue Jay fan, but he's definitely safe here on this slide.
10 yards. He has carried 8 times for 41 as the quarterback, Joe Gagliardi. How could you ask for more? Over the middle, and it is complete to a man who's on the ground at the 12-yard line, and they rule that it's complete.
Well, that's perfectly acceptable. You can't advance the football when your knee touches the surface, but Scott Allen, who has caught a couple today on the ground, grabs this one for 15 big yards, and it's just concentration all the way. I know I'm going down. I've got to watch the football. I have to watch the football. I'm going to follow it right into my chest.
4 catches, 57 yards. Rutgers now with a first down at the BC 13. Here they come again. Look at Gagliardi bring them back. Fires it. It's caught and dropped at the 5-yard line. Pass was intended for Matt Prescott, and the linebacker was there, number 53, Bill Romanowski. And so it stops the clock now with 3:33 to play in the game. 20-10 Boston College. They can afford to give up one score, but they certainly don't want to give it up too soon here and give Rutgers a chance to get it back.
That was real good coverage by Boston College. Gagliardi really didn't have a man to throw the ball to, but he gambled and threw it for Prescott.
Hoover goes wide to the left. And to the bottom of your screen, Eric Young, who made that critical grab on fourth down. This is second down 10 for Joe Gagliardi. He's gone all the way quarterback. Throws it in the end zone, and it's too high. And Joe had to deliver the ball because the pressure was coming, and the booing is coming from the Rutgers fans in that end zone, thinking that perhaps the receiver was knocked down, and even if he was, the ball was not catchable.
Hoover, the intended receiver. Gagliardi with plenty of time. And Hoover goes down. We did not see if he was pushed down or not by Neilite. No flag on the play. Rutgers fans on the far side of the field don't like the call at all.
Third down and 10 from the Boston College 13. Hoover goes wide left and Young to the right. Allen, that very valuable tight end number 88, strong side to the left, and Prescott's on a wing. Gagliardi's intercepted at the goal line. And going down with the ball is Carl Pellegata, the senior safety. Mike Ruth had the pressure on the quarterback, forcing the delivery of the ball right into the hands of Pellegata. And so Boston College has dodged a bullet here. And more importantly, I would think at this stage, with 3:19 to go, fairly well assured themselves of their third victory of the year.
Well, Pellegata just dropping. He's the free safety. He has the option to go anywhere he wants to. And I could have caught that one very easily, I'll tell you.
I thought it was intended for you.
Well, Rutgers is going to say that they got a tough, bad call in the last play. It should have been pass interference. If so, they would have had the ball at the 2-yard line instead of here, giving the football up, and Boston College now in a position to eat up a lot of the clock.
Ken Bell for a couple of yards. He stacked up by the middle of the Rutgers line, and that's exactly what Jack McNeil wants to do now, is work on the clock. Number 19, Chuck Gregory, comes into the lineup, and Bell remains there. Bell is now going over the 100-yard mark, 18 carries, 102 yards. And there's your story of the football game. You cannot give the ball up 6 times and expect to win.
I agree with you.
And As a result, Rutgers will lose again for the third time this year, presumably, with one great tie to show for their effort. But that's a little consolation to Dick Anderson. I'm sure you feel that way, Bruce. I know he does. He's got to win. He's got to get his team thinking they can win. I've come away from here, or will come away from here in a few minutes after Rutgers spends a timeout, thinking that I've seen one of the best college defenses in a long time.
Well, I think realistically that you can't call this game over yet. There's still 2:35, and if Boston College gives up the football, a lot of things can happen. But in any event, Rutgers defense has done a fine job this afternoon. Boston College put together two or three good marches, and that really was it all day. They had to use the ground game more than they used the passing game, which was kind of surprising. And the Rutgers offense moved the ball on occasion, but they just could not sustain it enough to get some points on the scoreboard. You can't win with 10 points.
So the fourth quarter, which has normally been the bugaboo to the Boston College Eagles, has been a good quarter to them. They have outscored their opponent here, or at least they've outscored them 7-0 here in the fourth quarter. The one touchdown by Rutgers came near the end of the third quarter on the Gagliardi pass to Bruce Campbell. And they've done very well themselves to come up with their third victory. If in fact they can hold on here for another 3 minutes. But you are right, this game is not over. Halloran rolling right. Looking downfield, avoids one tackler, delivers the ball, and it's almost intercepted.
Wow, you don't want to do that.
Oh, my goodness. And so on fourth down, they'll have to kick it away, and most importantly to Dick Anderson. They've stopped the clock with the incompletion. He doesn't have to spend a timeout.
There's really a lot of time left. I know you have to score twice, but 2:32, stranger things have happened. I'll tell you a story about a Rutgers-Boston College game in just a couple of moments.
Steve Peach now, just in the shadow of his own goalpost, will hit this ball at about the 5-yard line. And Will Dunster, back at the 20, at the 45, to return it for the Rutgers Scarlet Knights. High snap. Peach comes down with a good high punt. Great hang time and distance. Dunster at the 45. And he runs out of room and out of bounds right there at the 46-yard line. A return of one after a punt of 40 yards by Steve Peach. And the man downfield was Joe Giaquinto. And so Rutgers gets the ball back with 2:22 to play.
It was 1982 at Chestnut Hill, Massachusetts. Rutgers against Boston College. And Boston College was trailing in the game 13-6. The Eagles moved the ball 87 yards in 87 seconds. An incredible march with Flutie at the control. They score a touchdown to cut it to 13-12 and then add a two-point conversion with 12 seconds left to win it 14-13 over Rutgers in one of the great comebacks in college football.
Still the precedent is there. Here's Gagliardi, long downfield. McPherson almost with a great diving interception. Garrett McPherson had the great position of the receiver Eric Young and almost came down with the interception. You know, we praise the defense. We'll take a look at this one again, and as you see it again, we praise the defense of Rutgers, but let me also point out that Boston College's defense has given up an average of 30 points a game this year. They're at 10 right now with a little over 2 minutes to play, so obviously they have done something right today as well.
I think it's fair to say that the defenses have excelled today on both sides, and the offenses have certainly not.
Gagliardi on second down and 10 from just over his 45-yard line. Out of the backfield, Prescott intercepted! And by Romanowski as he took the deflection. And that is the seventh turnover for Rutgers today. And Joe Gagliardi is a very disappointed young man as he loses his shoe and rips off his chin strap. But that's just the break. That was certainly not his fault.
This is definitely a tough break. The ball is in the receiver's arm. And it bounces off the bottom part of his shoulder pad and right into the arms of Romanowski, who's like a cobra waiting to swallow up anything that comes near him. He has played a great football game, Romanowski. You can use that term, don't you think so?
I think that would not be overstating the case at all. There have been a couple of players who have performed, have given great performances today. Snow is one of them, and certainly Romanowski. You know, the odd thing about this game that you might examine, Bruce, is the fact that, for whatever it's worth, Rutgers came into the game with a giveaway takeaway ratio of +3, which means they have received the ball by fumbles and interceptions three more times than they've given it up. On the other hand, BC came into the game -5. BC today is +4, and Rutgers, as you know, is -4. So, you know, how can you count on these things?
Think of a way of evening out.
Working on the clock now with 1:30 to play. John Halloran, just content, not one of his great afternoons. The youngster who threw for over 400 yards against Pitt, went four games in a row for throwing over 200 yards, did at least keep alive his string of consecutive games of throwing a touchdown pass. Today was his fifth straight, a 35-yarder to Kelvin Martin. But it has not been one of his better performances as a senior out of Westminster, Mass.
Well, looking ahead on Boston College's schedule, if they win today, they will be 3-3. Next week, they are at Army, undefeated football team as of today. Then they are home to West Virginia, at Cincinnati, at Penn State, at Syracuse, and home to Holy Cross. So, conceivably so, if Boston College gets things going in the second half of the year, they can finish with a nice season. As far as Rutgers is concerned, they'll still be looking for their first win if things hold up today at Temple next week. And Temple, a very solid football team. Paul Palmer, perhaps a Heisman Trophy candidate. Can we go that far? Certainly a dangerous running back. And after that, Pittsburgh, Richmond, Tennessee, West Virginia, Colgate, and Syracuse. So the schedule is certainly something awesome.
Halloran's going to throw it again. And he is back at the 43-yard line. That Temple-Rutgers game, of course, you'll be able to see here on the TCS Sports Network next Saturday afternoon from the Vet in Philadelphia. Jim Pacal with the sack. And so on fourth down, Steve Peach will come on to punt again. Will Dunster in single safety.
Boston College with 220 yards on the ground. A lot of that in the second half.
Well, there is nobody back. Now Dunster, or is it? Yeah, it is Will going back to the 20-yard line. Thought for a minute, Scarlet Knights would come with all 11 men and try to block the punt, but they send Dunster back in single safety. And the clock is stopped with 1:21 to play in the football game, and Boston College leading Rutgers by a score of 20-10. Isn't it odd that roller coaster continues? Win 1 week, lose the next. Win 1 week, lose the next. They have on alternate weeks won and lost have the Boston College Eagles. And it's been a strange season for Jack Bicknell.
I like that theory. You presented that early in the telecast. It holds up. What do you think they'll do next time?
I don't think they like it. They want to win a ball, that's for sure. I don't think he wants to go through a 500-year. Peach with another good high spiral. Dunster will field it at the 18. He has no place to go. And he is dragged down by Giaquinto at the 18-yard line. And so with a minute 12 to go after a 39-yard punt, Rutgers will try to put it in play. I believe they have one timeout left. No, they have no timeouts remaining. Boston College has two timeouts, and Rutgers has none. With a minute 12 to play, Gagliardi will have to go to work now and use the sidelines from his own 19-yard line. Rolling to the right, pressure. Grabbed and thrown down at the 13-yard line by Mike Degnan. Senior out of Norwood, Mass. 6'4", 253. Gets the sack at the 12 or 13-yard line. And the clock continues to run with 54 seconds to go. While we have a moment, I again want to thank our outstanding crew, our spotter Ted Bean, our statistician Charlie Fisher, and our stage manager John Grohol. All hail from Altoona. We get him up here in a bus from Altoona. Home run ball, McPherson going for it. It's deflected and incomplete, stopping the clock with 37 seconds to play. The pass intended downfield for number 85, Greg Raffelli, and they have not used him very well today at all. I don't believe he caught a pass.
I think if you look at the scoreboard, you can see that Rutgers has 15 first downs, Boston College 14. Total yards, very close for both teams. Bottom line, 7 turnovers for Rutgers and just 3 for Boston College, and I don't think you can win a football game by turning it over 7 times, and that was the difference this afternoon.
You had a quick look at Dick Anderson there, 44 years old, a Joe Paterno protege, offensive coordinator there at Penn State from 1981 on. This pass is completed to Hoover, who was hit at the 20-yard line. On a third down play, they get back to the original line of scrimmage. We'll have time enough for one or two more plays. It's fourth down. 9 to go now for the Scarlet Knights, trailing 20-10. They will go 0-3-1, and they have not been out of any of the games they've played. They have been most respectable, and after seeing them today, you can understand why. Their defense is just a very, very game bunch of young men. Look at that fourth down conversion. He's done it twice. The game doesn't mean anything, but he completes the pass to Hoover to keep the drive alive at the gun, and the football game is over. And so Boston College has defeated Rutgers by a score of 20-10. That is our final score, and we'll be back with our post-game report from the Meadowlands in East Rutherford, New Jersey, right after this.